another Linux live stream. The new glibc and binutils version were released, and on the other channel, as you know, we run this Linux distribution, cross-compiling, if you're new to this channel, cross-compiling and search to all architectures. And actually I wanted to live stream an FPGA update because amazing progress here, but instead probably let's test the latest and greatest, let's see what could possibly go wrong. So update glibc, this build will take a little bit, even though on the AMD Ryzen I hope actually, so sometimes like stuff like completely breaks, let's see how this fares today. And even on this Ryzen 3950X it will take a little while because not fully parallel configure and whatnot stuff, so binutils. Let's see, yeah, so let's test this. On the other channel, on the MoreLife channel, earlier today we already updated or fixed some LLVM Mesa stuff. So last time we did this, we had some LLVM Mesa breakage. The compiler infrastructure and open source 3D library there, framework stuff. So let's give this a try. Let's wipe the whole build stuff because actually, wait a second, I think without specifier probably should clean all of those. So let's see how well this will be going. Hopefully also how many, already 7% drop frames, not amazing stuff. Garbage cable docks stuff. So then, I also slightly wonder, do we have a verbose flag in? Maybe build this verbose, otherwise it's maybe too boring. So config x86, of course we built here AMD 64, so AMD x86-64 config, and then we enable tempfs, disabled from testing earlier. Also we might find ourselves disabling enabling this pretty quickly because build errors. Let's see how fast the 3950x gets us to such build errors, because nothing will get stuff failing as quickly as that. Let's open another in parallel. Let me just authenticate here because reasons. And in parallel, we can already clean up here. In parallel, we could actually tackle some also if we were positioned. Let's quickly check that. So yeah, welcome everyone who is new to this channel. Actually, maybe we position this so like somewhat, not really tiling, but somewhat. Then we have the build going in full detail, because theoretically there were at least one issue Python related from the earlier build. What was this diff thing here, by the way? Oh, this was a GCC diff. Okay, what was that? So yeah, 32 threads, recurring theme here, 32 threads, 16 cores, and serial configure stuff. But anyway, this stuff mighty fast. Only here, as usual on this channel, building the latest and greatest open source stuff while it's hot there. Just that is this fine tea. So yeah, let's see some people tuning in. So unfortunately this might take a little while, especially this is a minimal Xorg build. Also there are CPIO. Actually, you know what, now that I see this, maybe it would be even cooler. The status thing here we just changed the other day. Previously this verbose stuff didn't print the package, and it's even like printing this in each line, so this is using some carriage return magic to carriage return there to print this over. I just wonder, it would have been, so it would certainly probably be cool if we have the stage level in there. Maybe let's do that actually pretty quickly. That shouldn't be also here. Binutils, and then it fails. That is or some globbing stuff. No, that is fun. No file to patch. So yeah, another proof only live on this channel. 32 threads at 4.something gigahertz get you to build errors rather quickly. So it looks like maybe the file just changed. Let's hope if we can quickly. This is the only thing for both here. Oops. I slightly wonder, do we have build target? Previously I mentioned I never used this. Do we have here verbose for dash f? No, we don't. Maybe I actually hack this in also then later, because we have some time here together live on this channel, because even on the 3950X it will probably, the last time it was like more than 2 hours. Also another time, so maybe at this time more people tune in. I certainly don't give up the hope of spreading some Linux entertainment and learning experience here. So binutils, this is patching file. Let's find here name elf32em. And okay, that is completely gone. No, that is fun. Where is the linker? Emule something. Emule 10. Pull and then elf. Okay, they have elf em and x86 and elf generic. No, what fun stuff. So let's look up this file conf dir. That should be patch file name. Did I just scroll this away? Probably off. Okay, then not. Probably something with RLD glob. Obviously, so this is patching here. Most likely this is some generic or whatever. Code from minutil something. So this is patching in the few patches we have of some trailing comments. Where do we normal dir no include? Nah. Just looking for some common, okay, some path info, some info parse, I guess. So that was info parse, and let's quickly check. We found this in there. Let's maybe they just renamed this or something. I would hope. Path info path no fun stuff. Okay, that is let's just then be generic. Okay, that certainly is not there. Is this file entirely gone or what? No, this is of course not the most amazing start here. Let's see, some people tuning in. So welcome everyone if you're new to this channel or fun of low-level hardware and software fun. It's maybe, what was it, info path. IXM, okay, thank you very much. I mean, we could start the build without this. Darn, how could they just move that thing around? There is, should be some, I mean, somewhere they should have this somewhere. Let's one quick look. Then this is only used for like file name globbing in the ldsoconf. One of the very few features that we patch in there. Invention of mine. Probably I got tired 15 years ago of hard coding all the parses. This was EOF or something. Are you freaking kidding me? Ah, LD elf. What is this doing? Elf emulation code target using elf emulation after parse. Oh, come on. Ah, here's info parse. So yeah, that could maybe. So if you're super lucky, they just moved it around a little bit. So let's echo pvd that and copy and paste this part and manually apply that here without you could actually test this. Did I copy the whole path with binutils? Okay, I did. So then Yeah, the date will be wrong. Very theoretically, I could really rediff this, but sometimes I'm just feeling lucky. Of course, yeah, 2004, how old are those rediffed patches and major distributions? We could actually, the best thing would actually be not trial and error, but actually test this. So that would be patch manually 11.fn, what was it even? Come on, LDLF and conf dir LD something and must be create. Maybe this is not VI. What do we even do here? Hey, succeeded. Yeah, just a little bit name. So quickly we fix here the stuff. 20 years of experience and good luck. So, GMP was updated. Oh, cool. Let's quickly GMP. Thanks for that. And the comments here, Glocos are. Thanks for asking. We are doing fine. We made huge progress on the FPGA front. I could tell you why we built this. And it was updated. If you want to use the latest GCC92, if you're going to use GMP 6.2.0, looks like we have that currently. And GCC, probably we have this, don't we? 9.2. Yeah, we had this, but thanks. Why would you build some basic things like, so the Rickland asked, why would we build such basic things? Yeah, because we built a whole Linux distribution doing this for 20 years, formerly known as Rock Linux, founded by Claire Clifford Wolf. And I came there relatively early. I was maybe the 10th or 20th person to join in 1998, recurring theme here. So we do this whole Linux stuff here, ourselves, T2 SDE for also cross-compile support, supporting all the architectures that are left behind by the major players like Spark, PowerPC, HPPA, MIPS, everything in between, but also x86, certainly AMD Ryzen and RISC-V and ARM and other fun stuff. So yeah, this builds again. Moving files around just causing, well, it's a little bit our fault of not having this amazing feature upstream, but usually distributors like Debian and Red Hat, like YOLO, whatever, go away with your patches. So eventually I also give up. And so this is, but it's a little bit, yeah, code refactoring and then breaking. Let's see what else breaks today. I'm really curious. Also, if you are into such fun stuff here, there's also Instagram of here my channel. I posted already if you want to follow some stuff. I made amazing progress, as you obviously see here, on the FPGA front. Actually, I wanted to live stream this, but this is either delayed for after this stream. Is it even in focus? Let me just also know I lost some wire. It's somewhat in focus. So yeah, Icebreaker FPGA stuff because I couldn't resist and it's just too much fun. So graphic mode, I have no dynamics. So not only text mode perfected, that was already yesterday or so. Here of pixel perfect, not off by one, amazing FPGA text mode because amazing. For a homebrew RISC-V fun here on FPGAs. But then this was the first status update of, yeah, I re-enabled graphic mode, actually, or re-implemented graphic mode that is also should be perfect. Of course, due to the limited memory, we only have 15K of memory there in the FPGA left, so 128K for the RISC-V CPU. And 15K, of which we are using 12 for simplicity. So this is, I didn't add more graphic memory here, but then later, another hour later, I fixed this of using the character. So we now have a completely fully working 8K frame buffer plus 4K character set, and we can, in the graphic mode, they are combined. So the first 8K go until here, then as you see this repeats this garbage, by the way, it's just the text mode stuff, it's the firmware printing their text. This is why this text is not matching to the, doesn't matter, just it's like our firmware is like printing text mode character points there, so that is why that's not matching. And yeah, so this are 8K until there, and then here I combines it. So in graphic mode, we have 8K frame buffer plus 4K character set stuff. So some unified 12K VRAM, good for 320 by 240 one bit, just like amazing Apple, whatever, 2 or whatever that probably was stuff. Anyway, amazing stuff, and we can dynamically switch this. So, but just give you an overview while we are waiting for this stuff. And waiting, we have one more thing. So really curious how much stuff this will break. Usually I'm used that Binute and Glibc break quite some stuff. So we could experience also, yeah, breaking stuff this mount. Something is also a bit regression. Previously this was not printed. Eventually we also should get rid of this stupid message there. And Carlos has a question. What's the frame buffer device? What is the frame buffer? I mean, FB. I know that you can run some graphic applications on this, but I don't understand what it is exactly. So frame buffer is just a super dump, like directly memory map without any acceleration function. So each, like even our FPGA, very theoretically, although it's a little bit memory constrained and stuff, but theoretically, it's a frame buffer. So even on Hercules and stuff, so frame buffer just means like writing with the CPU into the memory area. And because this is different on, well, there is VGA compatible, but all the super VGA stuff, all the registers, as per my previous videos, there are 20, 30 videos of low level programming stuff. And due to that, you need a driver also for other embedded boards, because TI, OMAP, and all the others, all the control register stuff, control register, as in here, this the stuff here on our FPGA in Verilog, and control, what are we even timing? That would be VGA, and I hope this actually captured, because I switched this, but I think, I guess it captures. So control register, meaning on which memory location you write some stuff, and this is why you need a little bit of frame buffer. And unless the BIOS, for example, on open firmware, PowerPC Spark, the firmware already comes up in graphic mode, then you don't really need the driver, you just continue writing there. On x86, it's a little bit more complicated, because the BIOS starts in text mode, as in such amazing stuff here, and this is text mode is not directly pixel mapped, and that is why the VESA standard is a little bit tricky, because that is running directly in real mode of all the x86 chaos and compatibility layers of old-fashioned stuff. And what are we even compiling? All right, I wanted to change this state printout. So this is why on x86 it's not nice for a protected mode operating system as Linux and others to call into the BIOS to mode switch on VESA, this video extension consortium stuff, because it's different. The registers, this kind of registers are different on all those cards, and that is why calling into the VESA BIOS with remote is a pain in the ass and not really nice, and could memory corrupt and totally annoying and whatever. So yeah, but in any case, it's barely used on Linux these days. They even talk about maybe deleting this in favor of full 3D drivers with direct rendering manager and not having frame buffer anymore. So yeah, whatever. The Rickland, probably you are new. We also do product reviews and other fun stuff here, the more in-depth stuff of some real computer scientist. Writing code, Verilog here, hardware. Verilog is new to me, or somewhat new to me, but otherwise C++ and whatnot. So running a Linux distribution, T2 SDE of this here, built from source like Gentoo, similar, old as Gentoo, before people ask why not Gentoo, because here, similar, founded in 1997-1999, so doing this 20 years, and today it's time to update Binutils and glibc and test what goes wrong. Usually something goes wrong. In the meantime, we wanted to, just for the fun of it, because then we would see here the state level if we change this. This was in org here with a flush somewhere. And because we wait now anyway, we have one other random build error to fix. That is the pre-compiled Python stuff. We need to adapt for Python 3 or something. Carlos asks what he must study to make maybe an OpenGL application run on the frame buffer. You probably want to use Mesa. Not really sure if maybe, probably, Don't run this on frame buffer, then you can probably do this. I'm not sure if Mesa has support there. That would be a little bit like Wayland or other compositors. So you wouldn't do, you could probably, if Mesa supports this, do direct GL or Vulkan on DRM, Direct Rendering Manager, or DRI, Direct Rendering Interface. But few people probably usually do this. That's probably, you maybe can look into how Wayland is implemented, I guess. Welcome, Christian. So here, this was what we've recently done. So here's stage level. So if we want the stage level in here, we can just print here also stage level that. And not sure maybe how this is a shell. Either then move to a hash, or what is a new shell is using? Okay, it's using an ampersand. So not really sure what I... Okay, let's, in the spirit of only changing what we wanted to change, let's change it like this. And what else could we do? So this, but you see, as soon as this stuff is building in parallel, unfortunately, we most likely, we can also already abort this and restart it, because we learned already, or I know, and we learned the other day, editing the text file will most likely break bash. I have the feeling it's memory mapped or some stupidity. So that is why, well, stupidity, it's stupidity as in not really necessary for a shell script. Because this means, because while we edit this, the bash probably has this memory mapped, and then all the shell script shifts, and probably the execution aborts anyway. So it makes no sense to wait another 3 minutes of LLVM finish building when it anyway will break or fail with some error. So reference, what we have, x86, 64. Did we re-enable? Okay, this is not really enable. It's x86 config, not that. So probably it should work, but you never know. But it is a devtempfs. No, it does not look so. Maybe do we? Yeah, probably we waste here right now some performance, I guess, writing to USB, maybe, should probably, anyway. So yeah, this might, what else? So the Python error, now I cleaned all the build, it was very clever. The Python error was something, sorry, probably time for more tea. The Python error, I can check Python. I would think Python has already something, but maybe it only works for Python 2. Let's see, parse, and yeah, welcome comrades there in the audience. Thanks for tuning in. So does this, so actually here is some, actually it has here some filter out access to module registration. Why would this not work? Is Python now, no, actually we track this. Actually, this is, okay, we will see for the build error. So as you see here, all the 32 cores nicely loaded. Not much. All right, we want IT87. That doesn't auto-load anymore. Probably should either. This is also really stupid, honestly. Also somewhat stupid, this module doesn't load IT87 for sensors and 61 amps, and what are the temps here of 75 core, where are 73. Also really stupid that there is all this ACPI complexity, that there is not like some or correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't see there some generic sensor stuff. That is also really, I mean, as with all the complexities, the one thing that is still, I mean, why do we even need this IT87 drivers that then have resource conflicts? It's welcome everyone, and Osama, WAP or so. One day you make your own distro. Yeah, well, with T2, of course, you can automatically. I personally see not really that much point of like manually making your own, especially as time-consuming and error-prone it is. So, in my opinion, something like T2 or Gentoo for this matter, but certainly T2 for all the more readable shell scripts. And really keeping this T2, in my opinion, correct me if I'm wrong or if you have any other data points, I really prefer this for all the raw, like in Sushi and plain vanilla stuff. Here the code is readable, shell code and not Python and whatnot. As I know people love Python and stuff, but nothing beats, in my opinion, shell code for scripting what you would normally, I mean, you don't run Python on a shell, right? There is a reason you run a shell for the shell, not Python as a shell. So that is why I find this much more natural to script building an application, scripting a distribution like this. Of course, Python has its means for data processing and science and whatnot, but in my opinion, probably maybe this is slightly more convenient as more close to the admin shell anyway. So yeah, but maybe you want to try out T2 for that. Let's see, I'm slightly wondering what we optimize here. Should we change this a little bit? I mean, what do we optimize? We optimize here for speed. Maybe either, so actually I could pull up my own benchmarking from the other year that I probably have in here and check how much faster, because in some ways it doesn't make sense to optimize for speed here if it just is holding us up where we are waiting for. Wait a second, why did I disable did I disable verbose, or why is this why is this not verbose outputting anymore? How did I manage to do that? Strange stuff. Only live on this channel. Always the most curious stuff happening. Where was my was it open bench CPU test or so? And then a display of stats2 of build time PNG. So this is all the previous videos. Massive vintage stuff. So build time. Actually, this is so wrong. Do I not have? Where do I have the other results of? This was. I also have compiler somewhere. Or did I? Or maybe I moved the results around. Yeah, results. Vintage move results to results and then start. Probably what was this? I guess. And yeah, so now we have, so it's probably even slightly cooler here with the stage level, then we see a little bit better the progress, whether we are in stage 0, 1, 2, 3 and stuff. So let's display that again. So build times, this were all the compilers as seen on the previous videos, many videos of testing stuff. So if we compile here GCC, this is all the LTO stuff. Why do we have like regular GCC OS and this is stupidly sorted, unfortunately. No, this is really hard to follow. All right, I probably changed the sorting. All right, because, darn, this is, I had this specifically. Anyway, before we make too much of a science out of this, either we optimize for speed that doesn't speed it up that much, or we optimize for just with 0.1. Maybe we just do this and for just hopefully a little bit of we call this lazy for some, probably due to supporting Intel ICC a decade ago. We have here like non-lazy speed and something. Theoretically also we could map this differently to LLVM, so maybe in retrospect I regret this a little bit, that this is not the stupid speed lazy stuff, but that is what, never change a running system, I guess. So here, yeah, this is the change, you know, probably maybe slightly more readable. So this is still bootstrapping again, the T2, so fully automated. Obviously this is how I came to Rock Linux, and first it's bootstrapping a new compiler and stuff. And this is stage 0, then we are cross-compiling all the stuff. Of course, fully automated. So most likely, so we should really get very few build errors. We did a couple of live streams already, and so I'm not doing this to have here views or clickbait, because my pre-edited videos also have quite some pre-edited videos to come. These live streams do not get the most views, but we need to do it a little bit anyway, because, well, I could now go home and watch this scroll by, but can also entertain the YouTube audience here. Need to test it anyway. Have you ever thought about tiling Window Manager? Like, yeah, I thought about this. Of course, we packaged many of them even live on YouTube here, some updated and packaged, but somehow for me this feels more flexible. Like, this somehow I don't really like really get too used to that. So, but if you have comments or experience, just leave it in the comments below. I wish I really could get to the Python error. I slightly wonder, but probably this terminal should not, the terminal scrolling should not hold us up much, because it should scroll fully asynchronous to the build output. It's piping, coming out from the sandbox with some pipe anyway. I would think that probably should. Yeah, it's always, yeah, this is not only do I not usually run this for both stuff, mostly for the YouTube matrix, like Hollywood movie views here, but the other point is then also, but this is not even scrolling that fast. The point is only how much is this slowing the build down. Anyway, yeah, let's wait this. We also commit this, so as soon as it looks like somewhat working, of course, right now it's still bootstrapping, but as soon as we like not error out, but build some files, I will commit the binutils update. And then did we even, let's see, do we have glibc already built? So it's anyway, if glibc, then only the headers, which probably should already have, should be one of the earlier things, I think. LM log 0 glib. Here are the headers. Actually, we also need to, well, we are at a glibc32 also. Need to update this as well with a multi-lib. Maybe another day. As you see, there's always so much to do, which is also why I turn to this YouTube stuff here. Theoretically, this glibc32 is a rare package of multi-lib, of having a 32-bit variant. Theoretically, we could support this for more packages, so maybe eventually it would be worth to explore having generic multi-lib support. And so Easter Egg writes he's using i3 like 3-4 years now, exclusive, and really like how it brings you towards more minimal and flexible setup, took like D menu and the like, and there is no such more fun stuff you can do. Sounds well, maybe I tried a little bit more. USB interface doesn't like when this high CPU latency, it sends multiple times per second. What do you mean with USB interface doesn't like it when there is high CPU latency, it resets multiple times per second when host is building? What that is, what system is that? That would be interesting to know. Multiple CPU, that is funny though. That, so maybe this is actually, so in my opinion, this probably shouldn't happen. Maybe this is thermal throttling then, because that is the only thing when normally if you get an interrupt, it's handled like instantly as per interrupt priority. But if you get such a high latency, I guess it could only happen if the CPU is thermal throttling and the clock is held low or whatever, not clocking there for a significant portion. So maybe you want to look into that, but may otherwise CPU, and not only more, much more importantly would be the main board then for that, would be interesting to know. But yeah, and most of the tiling support floating Windows as a fallback. That maybe I try it. We have the T2 packages, and you're welcome to not only try it out but send some packages, patches and stuff. We could actually, well, while we are at it and not waste time, we could actually theoretically sort here through the mess that is my working copy here in the non-clean tree. Of course, we have quite some stuff here, as you see. Obviously, also can delete this and kind of whatever. So, what is in scripts commit though? Oh, quite some stuff. What have I done here? Message something. What have I done here? No. Some message support. I don't even barely remember that. Why do I have this so long around here? So for this for loop, what have I done here? While. Okay, this is parsing that if not exist or echo something location. If message, not really need to review so much to here. So many changes here and there and data center and stuff. OS means that I scrapped some API, but seems like low level thing might give. Yeah, I mean, it probably should work. You just, as I said, you probably just need for your direct DRM stuff, look into how Weston or whatever the compositor is there handles it. Intel, okay, this Perl weekend. So this probably one of the few. So a few errors I will just skip over here as last time, but each time we will fix some. I'm just not, this is just too stupid for me to spend time on. It's like, yeah, whatever, YOLO, let's continue here. But many other we fixed. So there was a regression with Manson, or Manson? Oh, bloody new Manson or Mason, it's always Mason. So there was some regression with Mason, maybe development version or whatever, and a couple of other stuff. So actually many of this stuff already fixed. What do we have here? BB keys, what is with this thing? Maybe commit here some stuff while at it. What is it? Var append, or this probably I guess hotfix. Not really sure what. If I did this, it was probably needed, so whatever. What else? Mesa was the update today. We don't really need this because we changed this, so yeah, whatever. This other thing, so this was live on the other channel. I tested the release candidate, it's probably revert. And maybe this also, this comments or whatever, don't really. What else do we have here? PDF, I think this PDF edit did still not build, even so maybe I just commit this and call it a day. I think I rediffed there and whatnot, but I think it wasn't like fully working, but a little bit working. So yeah, whatever. Probably better than before. It's up and done there anyway, so whatever. I packaged netserv now that I see this. Did this work? Netserv just packaged this for the fun. Hey, this even works. Or maybe I should not run it as. Did I not package this? Did I not commit this already? Package netserv not on another machine or. Apparently not. Okay, then let's commit this. While we wait for the build to continue. Wait a second, why is this empty though? Oh, not net zero of what? Oh, that explains the thing. Then what else? What did we do with that thing? Apparently, I think old compiler didn't grok that. Okay, fine, let's revert this. What was it? Yeah, this is probably the next time something doesn't work, I will do this differently, not really important, whatever. Docbox X, MPR, what is with this thing here? Qt, no AVX. I think this anyway didn't build. This was probably due to some muselibc stuff and whatever. Here is something. This is probably this Python stuff we can all delete, I guess. Not really sure from what that is, but because if it's not needed in a rebuild and don't really remember, don't need to commit random changes. Makes no sense. And what else? Edit does it here. What is this was some hack for the Hewlett Packard. So something is this, we also need another day. What was this init script here? I think once they moved the path, I write power on, I added. Might be not sure if I use this already. Oh, wait a second, but this bin can't be right. Why is this here some bin here? This should be HCI. This should be that here. Why is this path so such a garbage? This is why I always want to read the diff before committing and certainly test. Blue something. Power off and restarting. And yes, this certainly doesn't look right. Not really sure why this is such. But that theoretically we could maybe have some bin deer for that, but not really feeling lucky making experiments. This is mostly an attempt to on my portable setup where I have this wireless Bluetooth, usually not a fan of Bluetooth stuff, but not really using it much, but for traveling I was once working on this, so probably it makes sense that eventually keyboard and mouse auto reconnect should work on T2 of enable Bluetooth power on startup or whatever. Good enough. What else? So Chromium on Google to something from another video. OpenOffice also not fully ready here. This is some cache, not really sure why I would have had that here. What is in this one here? Did I not commit here something? Or enable calendar? I'm not really sure if I like this. It worked though. I think this added some. I think it was in the official description on the Mozilla, so whatever. Enable calendar. Bird by default. So yeah, usually I could continue with some FPGA stuff, answer some emails. This build takes a while, but anyway, thought it's fun to share. What is here with this J? Also, this must be lingering around for a year or so. Maybe I should clean this more often. Also, this didn't even load. What was this stuff about? Nair, that is some 2.8 disk that didn't download because whatever. Okay, I'll check that another day. What other fine stuff? Xemix better. Libcl, what is this? So edit that. Don't even really remember what that was for. Maybe I should actually. This is not even. This is funny. For what did I even add that? LLVM, libclc. Okay, another day. Doesn't ring a bell. Some random garbage. Vulkan loader, what have we done here? Oh, added quite some stuff apparently. Build demos of. Vulkan info. That installs Vulkan info. That is fun stuff. It probably looks legit. Probably might have worked. Also a year old already, so whatever. What? Let's see, does this? This also adds a cache file for dependencies, so enable. What was it in Vulkan loader? So Vulkan loader, Vulkan info, I think. And edit cache. So, what else is going on? Evergreen. So, could be IO latency getting too high due to QEMU VM being passed through with more cores than there are available In my opinion, probably interrupt should still work. Are you sure it's not thermal throttling? Maybe. Are you there in thermal throttling temperature territory? Cause writes, projects with C use auto tools or Mason and Ninja instead of CMake. Why projects with C use auto tools or Mason? Well, in my opinion, we had this just on the other channel, not a great fan of Mason. To be honest, in my opinion, reinventing the wheel was not really improving much. And auto tools, yeah, auto tools are super annoying, especially this macro preprocessor of a macro preprocessor with this M4 stuff. Super, it was already annoying 20 years ago. It was when we did GSMP, the General Sound Manipulation Program, 20 years ago of multi-track recording. It was a total pain in the ass, and like you were like constantly wondering why does this macro M4 macro stuff so hilariously annoying. But reinventing the wheel with different annoying stuff doesn't really is not really much innovation and doesn't bring us much forward in my opinion. But yeah, also CMake, in my opinion, yeah, auto conf stuff is not amazing, but yeah, somehow I don't know, leave them in the comments below. As usual, here's, by the way, some make self. I think, oh, this was hilarious. Some garbage needed make self. What might this have been? This was so hilarious. I'm not really sure if that even... Ah, right. The VirtualBox garbage needed make self. That was hilarious. Does it even install this? Not really. Maybe I don't commit this stuff yet because it's also disks type in DC RAW and disk type probably. Not sure what I looked into there. VR compiling, so that is a benefit. Previously, I could have only guessed that it's a benefit of this imaging marker here of progress indicators fame. Let's see, 16 people. So, more stuff. QEMU, some random changes. What are this? Probably only disabling, re-enabling some stuff. Did I, by the way, where's my own video playing there? That is unnecessary. Yeah, this we revert. This is just some local, let's not build everything stuff that, of course, shouldn't go online. Perl, probably, so we added this recently for something, I guess. Not really. We can, so the cool thing is in T2, we can check which package this needs. So I could just commit this, and probably we just commit this, but in my opinion, nothing beats here. Instead of messing with apt-get and whatever RPM stuff, just var ADMF list, nothing beats here. In my opinion, this is a true spirit of Unix, of, if you even watch vintage videos here from the 80s, from the Unix guys. Why I love our Rock Linux inherited T2 stuff. Administration stuff, in my opinion, super, keep it stupid simple, plain text files. Just grabbing in the dependencies, so deb, other dependencies here, also best not misspelled. So nothing use it, so that is fun. Why did I edit this then? Not really sure. Maybe for something like VirtualBox though. I mean, we could just, did this even build log Perl. And this is also the difference with this Perl stuff, as much as I'm not using Perl, but yeah, that build for whatever reasons, no idea. Or maybe I just edited this and it was another package. So always, do I commit this or do I leave it lingering around here for even longer? But at least you can package this Perl and Python stuff. That is a sharp contrast. Ah, this is actually a real fix here. Did this build? Let's test build this of emerge v and missing only docbook x. Yeah, this looks like a build without error. Let's force it just to double check if this really builds correctly, but it sure looks like it. And yeah, Glaucus writes, yeah, auto tools are really annoying, but at least you can debug them, right? Normal shell script, so yeah, that builds. That is a real fix here. As you have seen with my other videos with Mesar and LLVM, where I couldn't even trivially see what the freaking heck is. Meson stuff there was doing until I figured after probably an hour of 30 minutes, one video, 30 minutes, another video, what was going on there, that just by pure chance and common sense that Mesa wanted the shared libraries there. And in a configure script, you could, in my opinion, just with the T2 script, just see the bloody shell code, what I tried to do there. Docbook X. So the real fix of this is that it was previously using just tar and that with J, and that doesn't just work anymore. So this is from converting our T2 archiver from previously, more than a year ago, tar to set standard. So that actually very theoretically, do we have some archiver variable for that, or either compressor or like function in or compressor or okay, there we have tar opt set standard. I slightly wonder, can we run set standard dash d with that though? Then we could use compressor. I slightly wonder, what do we use, or archiver instead of not hard coding that again. Set standard. We sure could test this. It's maybe not the prettiest. I think also on the other hand, most packages, I think we just hard coded this here. It's probably not the most amazing way to do this. Or do we, here is, standard, is it set standard? Or do we use compressor, or we use compressor? So then this apparently should work. Okay, then this certainly is slightly better. Yeah, compressor D. So then we should of course use that in docbook X. Conf. So set standard compressor D, fixing this once and for all. Even if we migrate to whatever next time, let's test build this another time. And what's going on here? Something breaking with, okay, this is LLVM, which is, this is also known, not really needed, it's just not finding libxml2, as you see there. But whatever, we don't, I said this before, I will optimize this selection of not building stuff. We do not strictly need to also cut down compile time a little bit, but for today, just touch this log file. Same goes for Mason, yeah. Exactly. So yeah, this still builds, and let's commit this. Also, I slightly wonder, theoretically, we could check with grep. Do we have some setcat or something similar? So we still have bsetcat. So this, okay, security, gr security, and vserver. Very theoretically, someone's still using this stuff. And okay, looks like we don't have really that many otherwise. Bsip, oops, also. Oh, we have here PHP, others installed. Apparently not really many. Maybe this is one of the very last ones though. Docbook X, and so we changed here only compressor. And the other thing is, to convert from cust main, which I want to deprecate, there are also not really many. Cust main is overwriting the whole main build function, and that is from very, very vintage, 2 decades ago, time before we converted to more flexible hooking event mechanism, like nowadays, since 15 years in Rock Linux, since 2003 or something, that was probably for Rock Linux 2 or so. We did this hooking that you have seen here probably, hook at pre-conf, pre-make, post-make and stuff, to hook additional stuff also for targets if you build your own custom firewall target and stuff. What is this? S-trace is now failing because I think this is a new regression, at least I think. One S-Trace, don't really remember, is it failing previously? What's going on now? Personality, although maybe it could be conflicting types for, yeah, that is a new regression for, I guess, glibc. But if we will see, so this is just a summary, I hope not. You never know, this is a thing, of course, with this YouTube. As you see, I need to do it anyway, either I sit at home now in the living room and with a laptop and stuff, or I live stream it, because live stream it, and that also documents this, of course, all the naysayers always like, yeah, it's no work and everything just works and whatever, and just, yeah, at least you can also polish all your other working copy changes while it. So, fix DocBook X 4 set standard compressor and not use custom main. So, yeah. And, yeah, so not making this. The thing is, of course, on the daily office day, I also have here some Gatling. Also, I sent something to Felix from Leitner. He changed it a little bit. I think he changed it, and his change broke something else so much too. So best of the industry, breaking their stuff. Because this stuff is just my vintage low-level local debugging stuff. So it's not really upstream versy. What would that be? This is some garbage of patching mostly. Let's take a look. What is this here? Oh, this is some, all right, this was probably from some LLVM ceiling build stuff. What would that are? So he's also removing no stuff and all error. I guess it probably should maybe theoretically be worthwhile in general, I guess. So probably we could actually commit that removing more stuff. So this is just removing, I guess, wait a second, one, no. I'm not even, I think I needed this because some package was using one or something with an old compiler on some old system where this didn't build, I guess. And this might have broken some Spark build or something with one error or something. Might slow down the build a little bit for globbing regex matching this, but I guess we can probably try to commit this, remove more. GCC parse config, remove more generic deron friends and whatever. Could, of course, friends or whatever, it doesn't really matter much though. Then here was some M stuff that usually my local changes, something of that sort. I mean, so far so good. I mean, so far only S-Trace broke. If not from the other live stream earlier today, I'll release this ISO image from all the other fixes. I wanted to check this first. This is kernel. Liberty. Yeah, this was probably just SUC. Actually, does it? So if kernel or, wait a second. If kernel and config script configure otherwise preconf, not native. Not really sure if that will break something. Okay, we don't really. I mean, this probably was fixing some MinGW build stuff as you see, but this could break something, I guess, maybe. But we could do it as, oh, wait a second, this is anyway the M file. Is it already committed, maybe? This is committed anyway. And this Liberty is also committed, as you see there. So then, RMZ. There was some more straight change. But this is also, when people wonder what takes all the time, this is just like janitorial work of cleaning up my working copy of on the data center. I showed it before. I have 300 changes on the data center. I don't even remember what this is though. What was this? What I was on another live stream. This was some good old fashioned tool of whatever sort. I just remember What is envy? What is envy? Or what would that be? I totally also don't quite remember. Maybe this is from PC emulator, something of, or what would be at gold? Maybe this most likely looks like PC emulator, not really. Maybe I just delete it here. No, it's gone, whatever. What is with FontForge? Some update maybe? Hey, some massive update. Apparently, although, why is there not a checksum in there? So that probably. Oh, not downloads. Why did it not download previously? Half working copy changes. So yeah, I'm slightly wondering also quite some, yeah, I mean, internet infrastructure, we pay for 400 or 500 Mbit down and 40 Mbit up or something, and then you can't even reliably live stream here with 5 Mbits. It's hilarious. 4000 drop frames, 4.1%. This is so sad. Yeah, this is actually, you know what, we could tackle this stupid, but this is also super annoying. This is just, you see the pain of C, and why you probably really, it's only new comp. I said this before, this is only this warning here appearing since a year or so. This will also not be the most fun to count this bytes manually to fix this. Let's see, FontForge, I should have used the, I mean, the only thing is this is V, at least you see verbose for having the log file there, ADM log FontForge. So here, it's building something. And it failed apparently. Probably explains why I didn't commit this. Undefined exit function. Fun stuff. Is just missing some linking to X11 stuff, I would guess. Undefined reference to X inter atom. Okay, fine, not really feeling like fixing that today. Editors, so this was Emacs, audio. Actually, here's some fun stuff. This was some garbage. What was that? This is an update. I think this fixed something, I guess. It's committed, probably shouldn't be too wrong anyway. Glaucus asks, what do you think of this Phoronix test suite for benchmarking distributions? I've never like really downloaded it. The issue is for me, it's too large anyway. Especially like comparing vintage systems. I mean, it's of course benchmarking something. The question, I mean, some of those are of course not really real world representative of some database and stuff. Of course, this is only if you run database. But I mean, at least he is catching sometimes some regressions in the Linux kernel. And of course, it, well, between distributions, but otherwise, it's of course benchmarking. The whole system, if you like to deploy a database, you can use it as some guidance. And between distributions, well, maybe we actually should do this. And well, very, very theoretically, if we would have too much time, then we could check with Intel's Clear Linux and stuff. They sometimes have apparently some performance configuration stuff that sometimes some performance gain is just like Python disabling, building with some symbol reduced, like B symbolic something, whatever, linker flicks or whatever I read once. And also Mason, oh, this was probably also some known stuff of, yeah, this whatever. Mason. Yeah, now we have some hiccup. But yeah, theoretically, as I said, we should probably investigate and peel out there all those changes. That probably would be quite useful. But yeah, time and stuff. But if you want to contribute, well, because theoretically we could like build the most highest performance stuff. But then on the other hand, I said this before, this is why I, after seeing LuaJIT outstanding performance, I'm now like pretty thrilled of more just in time compiled. I wonder how much more performance you get, because with Clear Linux or like classic software distribution, Apple, Microsoft and stuff, you have one binary to run there all, except if you run Java and .NET, whatever. But otherwise, it's really a pity that we have processor extensions. It's also a little bit the fault or the issue of x86 that we don't... what is this now? Glibc, look at that, clock set time, the next region, even in apparently glib of also this will, so much to that, thank you very much. This will of course cause a whole lot of build issues, but I wanted to say it's a little bit of the nature of this custom extension stuff of x86 that on if we would have just made stuff more massive parallel or something with all those vector extensions, maybe that would be more performant to generically support. But this is why, yeah, we could Google this if there's already a patch. Actually, maybe there's even a new glib version already, not really sure. At least we could try glib, also either we randomly try, or actually we could, it's this one, let's curl this URL here and cache JSON, which also means maybe late, so latest is 227 or 267, what, why is here so much latest stuff? What do we even have? We could theoretically check if glib desk, do we have here remove this update? Oh, probably maybe we want to remove this eventually, but let's see, the URL, does this give us usable? Hey, it does. The question is only what do we have right now? So 62. Grep plus what, so we have here quite some, so this probably should be unstable, so let's maybe try this one. So that would be, it's quite a bit of an update. This is also the issue of yeah, the subdirectory stuff doesn't auto scan very nicely, this is why I changed this to that. So if you're super lucky, that might fix this. But if we are super unlucky, it will not, and then we can still hunt for the stupid regression. But there you have it. You update your glibc and then some vital houses. Thank you very much. GIO, Mason build, no tests. Yeah, thank you very much. Failed, so yeah. Maybe was, but okay, maybe we actually try to rediff this to be. Otherwise, I have the feeling with this test we will have some. There was a reason I disabled that, if not for all performance. But yeah, as you see, certainly running a whole distribution can keep you quite busy for a while. And this is also why I want to automate this. So, yeah, so next to this channel, definitely, I know I repeat myself a little bit, but this will really come soon now. Oh, so much rejected, thank you very much. Hello, can we also rejected, what did we reject there? Okay, this is subd tests. Tests, this should be if build tests, hey, they conditionalized it, yay, amazing stuff. And we only need to figure out this stupid option, this bloody Mason build file. Build tests, not Mason is cross-build, or is cross-build and has exit wrapper and tests enabled. Installed tests. Installed tests, metadir, does it have some bloody option? Or maybe we can install test. Find program, install tests enabled. Does it not have a bloody stupid simple disable test stuff or install tests, metadir? Yeah, but this is also recurring theme auto. At least this configure stuff you could read. I mean, this is hilarious. Ah, get option install tests. So maybe we are so lucky that we can now svnrm glib test. No. Ah, this is also the wrong package. Glib no tests, and then let's hope this better supports some. So we basically never want to build a stupid test because build time. And so that probably means var append mason opt. Also nowadays I usually use this in the hope that improves performance just a tiny little bit. So d equals false because garbage syntax. Let's see, what do you think about, sorry, this question we had already, but yeah, what do you think? There is this for Unix, but so theoretically we could, of course, we probably should run some tests and see where we can find some performance, but of course with D2 everyone can build their own, but maybe theoretically we, coming sometime soon, eventually, undefined references, this, thank you very much, is still not fixed in the latest version. I slightly wonder, does it build regularly, so maybe build glib to check if it native builds. And yeah, so this, fixing this, not the most amazing, because whatever. So most likely they are hiding some more. Also, this is half of the error message. So yeah, strace fails, glib fails, so much to yay, we have a new glibc version. And glib, glibc, and of course this was not enough, of course we find here, maybe we just search just this in general, clock get time, set time. I mean, you should also glibc package 2010. Thank you very much. Did this even build? What happened here? Oh, this is still, is it still building? Or maybe we stupidly suspended it. Well, we could touch this for a second, but this will break some stuff. This would only be to check if this gets up past the bootstrapping, but most likely this will. I mean, not only does this error out now on package config and whatever needs this, but we could check if rebuilding glibc and stuff, if this is some cross-compile fluke, but most likely it isn't. So yeah, this will fail now without glib, because yeah, obviously, what syntax error unexpected, what, why does this error out so strangely like that? So yeah, again, this is just a test. I expected some build errors, but not like glib. This is not really, really annoying. I slightly wonder, 2010, good old fashioned, whatever. Been a lot of conspiracy around Phoronix, no idea of any, what? There's been a lot of conspiracy around Phoronix. What do you mean conspiracy around Phoronix? Let us know, I missed. But one thing I should say is that I'm getting really tired of all the many Linux versions there recently was like Intel Clear Linux. Why do we need Intel Clear Linux except that small companies like ours, but all the other independent people, they built some open source, even in Germany, some other Pangotronics and and stuff, and then like automotive and whatnot. But then Intel of all companies needs to come along and try some Linux operating system and distribution stuff. That's also, in my opinion, super annoying. The 1110s, I think recently I wanted to even make a video, maybe I still make it. So the 1010s distribution, was this even Huawei, or I actually even forgot Huawei Linux distribution, or I really, so there are so many, right, Euler, it probably was Euler. And then our, we also, I probably have some, was this announced recently or commercial Huawei based on CentOS? I have the feeling this was recently announced introduction here. Recently. Yeah, so they also, Huawei, they have their Harmony amazing microkernel OS, but then the Linux distribution. But this really pisses me off. I mean, 100 Linux distributions not enough? Do we really need 1000? Of course, you cannot forbid people to make a Linux distribution. But I mean, this is really silly that Intel and Huawei and stuff, especially if Huawei are saying they have their Harmony microkernel stuff. I mean, why? I would rather appreciate previous videos here, Harmony, Huawei, if this ever comes. Maybe this is so much vaporware that our own microkernel, vaporware kernel we talk about, will be out sooner than this stuff from Huawei. So let's see. Guys, sleepy, so get to least checked out in the morning. So yeah, I'm not really sure what we will release here, because as you see, causing some regressions depending on what we could try to use. Actually, the did we actually finish? So the interim resort, we could actually see if using the instable version maybe has a change for that. Glib, no, this is also built here. What did this build? Oh, this is just JO module, but in general, this apparently built here. That should be from just now. So 2241, yeah. Okay, this is a grub. We have seen this from previous builds. This is some whatever. Don't really care right now. I think it actually native build, so also we don't really. Yeah, there's some cross compile, autoconf, whatever stuff. So probably we can commit this update, it build. Update glib. So actually, maybe we should check the log file if it builds the tests. Let's see, gtest configuring something. So it looks like it's building some tests. So I have the feeling this disable test stuff, garbage stuff, doesn't really work. So maybe we still disable that after all. I slightly wonder if we can. Anyway, let's commit this first. Doesn't really quite, you know what, let's not commit the test part yet, although then it will be okay. Such shit. Okay, let's as soon as we have not yet up cleaned this, so we can still go in here. I guess it should be glib that one. We can still rediff that here, probably should be that. Maybe let's do this right, because I don't want to waste so many CPU cycles for that. By the way, okay, so we are now native build, so at least the new glibc stuff doesn't segmentation fault, core dump stuff. We are natively running new, freshly bootstrapped stuff here live on this channel. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for that. Also Perl, yeah, this, we also need to fix that. This is also known already, but yeah, details. Maybe another live stream, another week and stuff. And find name. Reject. This was not that. Pity. Then which else could it be? Maybe that. All right, probably was the first. Let's see. Reject. So let's see. So this and that should test. So yeah, subdir tests in subdir tests in Z. Does it hopefully maybe work like that? And that was it tests, or it was GIO. So, something failed like bin utils because, yeah, what failed here now? But there you see, as soon as stuff keeps failing, things become more hectic. And then, of course, it's at least somewhat worse while command pod to man. Thank you very much. Needs some. This Perl command not found. What? I think the last time. All right, we could actually native build Perl just for. Do we have here three Perl? Jobs. This happens when you skip some bootstrapping of Perl stuff. Basically, some people thought that tweak the results in favor of a particular hardware vendor was mentioned on level 1 tech videos from SMS, but it's there somewhere. Interesting. Whatever. Best without stage name typo. That's interesting. I didn't know this. I mostly go to this site to get some updates for. But this is also why we do this YouTube channel, not using their benchmark. However, maybe my small scale benchmark of open bench stuff, maybe we should improve this to have some more independent stuff. You also need to be careful if I've been careful a decade ago with this Linux Magazine articles that you are not accidentally building assembly optimizations. I accidentally noticed this very early when I was benchmarking like libmet or something of MP3 encode or decode, and it didn't really change much. And then I eventually figured that this was using mostly assembler code anyway. So, this was a stupid error. What did we have to rebuild for that? This was GCC, I think. This stupid multi-byte-ling crap. What annoys me from Phoronix is actually that he has so many, he's totally like page views and clickbait, which pisses me really off. What is really annoying in my opinion is this, there's soon something coming and then it's like, then I think it's released and then it was like, no, it's only coming eventually, which like bloody you don't need to make on your news site each small poops of maybe in a week or two there will be something. It's like there's also a limit of overnewsing of I think it was even the case for glibc. So here's glibc is nearing so this is like, yeah, I thought like, yeah, a week or two, and then even just like 7 hours later or something, like, hey, glibc is there. It's like, wait, what? It's like here. Usually there is more like a week or two. It's super annoying. I start my update and then it's like, why is the update not loading? It's like, oh, it's only a pre-announcement and not like a real announcement. This is a little bit annoying in my opinion. Yeah, another bit, you see there is still a little bit of small stuff. Again, a decade ago, everything builds all those interdependencies or new breakage of Perl not cross-compiling. This is a little bit my fault of not tweaking the Perl cross-compile glue. But the other stuff here is, for example, this multi-byte length stuff is a GCC regression also, because this cross-compile stuff did not occur like this. This is some new, maybe GCC8 or whatever, regression of this stupid stuff happening. How long are we into the 1 hour? So yeah, probably the issue is this is not the full Ryzen 3950X build time, because we have here some error diagnostic and fixing in between. So this is a little bit delaying this. Actually, there is something which is, what do they have here? Novo of Alphostem. Anyway. So we should soon have, what else do we have? Theoretically, we could already, as we have this maximizing here our use. All right, we need to finish this here. Also, now I closed the wrong ones too many. And then let's glib. And uh, And div the conf probably to be reverted because it doesn't work anyway. Let's see, no tests maybe. What is here with GCC fails now? And thank you very much for that, amazing. Did we build multilib or did we build, why is glibc failing now? Don't leaving what leaving directory object dear. Hello. Oh, here's something. Sanitizer of all recursive, here's something, sanitizer platform. So apparently you heard it here live on this channel. I guess the glibc update breaks GCC sanitizers. Size minus one of array searching failed. It's negative. Yay. Narrowing conversion of minus one from int long unsigned. So yeah, writing C like the pros of GCC and GNU development. Can't make this stuff up, GNU stuff breaking each other because that is for 2020. We probably, if this only is a sanitizer stuff, which I rarely use, we can disable this for a start. Like just have it here for a quick test, like that, and hope that this builds for now. Can't make this stuff up, not certainly not fixing this hard to follow and read and stuff. Code there, so no tests. Let's see if that builds without sanitizers, but yeah, just the usual stuff that is here. Live here documenting on this channel, not making this stuff, the stories up of like constantly for 20 years fixing build errors. And I'm really getting tired of that. Build package, I wanted to build test glib one last time before committing this no test stuff. And then we will turn to testing the glib development version that normally I wouldn't run, but just to test this with the glib compatibility. Slightly wonder where did I, or did I not even, maybe today I did not even unpack my MacBook here at work. So busy with Linux stuff. I actually wanted to tease the Phoronix people and post a link, but I didn't have my password saved there for that site on. Do I have Wi-Fi on? No, I have Wi-Fi on. Let's quickly post on Phoronix there. And so glib, so that we should also check if that, hopefully did glib not build the tests as patched away. Object dir. There are, for example, there are some tests, but okay, it did probably, but I think this is much less. Was it like lead 2000? Okay, there are apparently some glib tests or some GIO tests, but anyway, significantly less now. Let's commit this for now. And then source update list glib. And let's try this development version. Usually not a huge fan, but just in the hope. Being desperate for fixes. So glibc to commons. But this is of course a problem. Even big developers at Red Hat and stuff, they are not building their own stuff there, like they just tinker around on glib and stuff and don't even notice that they break strace and GCC of all packages, and then only the other infrastructure developers at Red Hat later notice that they broke their own stuff way later. So Phoronix test building. What is working now? Did even press something yet? So where we are still compiling, we can in parallel theoretically job one glib. Someone on the Phoronix forum is irritated. By the way, people in the audience, I'm still looking. I still have not found a proper Wi-Fi router. I want some new access points in here, preferably one where I can flash my own T2 Linux. If you have any recommendations for a open source Linux friendly router thing that is open WRT stuff compatible, which means we could flash our own T2 stuff for some more modern networking stuff. So GCC build, that means we can build Perl. I mean, this glibc we really need to have fixed. What was it, Perl we need to continue the rest of this stuff. And yeah, so even development version, so much to that. So yeah, this is a real showstopper. I expected some like S-trace. I didn't really like, I mean, GCC sanitizers is really wild. Also need new tea. Yeah, so all of them fail all the same. Very theoretically, can we probably already native test this? Do we have this in 3 or can we have only this in? Can see if native buildings this makes a difference, but most likely not. Also, this needs a Meson stammer. Yeah, fixing this, the problem is then this might be changing code. The fix for this kind of stuff is not small and easy, or well, maybe it is, but maybe it isn't. And unlocks one glib, because this probably means here some using some now private method here. Is this libRT undefined? Actually, wait a second, why is this in libR? So Perl build, so then we can continue with the rest of whatever was failing. Oops, but we definitely need to do something with this glib stuff. I think this, actually, wait a second, the first time was already this one here. Do we have? Why is this libRT undefined reference to setTime glibc private? Does this mean like this bug is already in glibc? Oh, darn it. Of course, no T2 with this build or tries to rebuild it. Yeah, regressions over regressions, just a regular state of stuff. 2011 already. Why is this such old stuff though? So yeah, S-trace, GCC sanitizers, glib, OpenSSL, the provisional, well, at least regressions. Let's see, something, yada yada, what is here, something useful. Undefined, what is here, in function, set time. There is triggered by, I suppose, and can you recompile with enable shared? And now, Now it compiles with shared. What does it mean? Don't tell me, but this is GIO GDBus. Does this look like static? Yeah, this kind of stuff I'm it's even linking here fuzzing stuff. As is, I would regularly build fuzzing stuff. Okay, this GIOG settings fails apparently here first. Yeah, Navarro, exactly, but someone needs to do this if the Reddit, but this is also, in a way, this open source, like IBM Red Hat, Oracle and stuff, also, yeah, using this other Gentoo and us and stuff as testers and, yeah, fixing all the stuff for upstream because, yeah. So far, Navarro, if you join new here to this live stream, So far we have regressions, S-trace, GCC sanitizers, and unfortunately glib, which is super annoying. I mean, a lot of the other stuff thankfully built, but I mean, without GIO, which is needed by package config and stuff, this is certainly now like really annoying. So all the applications fail basically. Undefined, so why would this be libRT though? Like this. I mean, all the other, but I mean, in general, it must be there because otherwise it wouldn't start now. The question is more like. It's not even having a private reference here. It's timer set time. What was it even less? For ADM glib, which almost was not this, it was one cross compile glib. Yeah, also, darn, this is a drawback of touching this because then. I wonder if just installing this lib glib, but probably this would also not work, like manually installing that just to have package config built, this probably would also fail. Here, this kind of regressions are really hilarious. Let's watch the scrolling by, make a tea, and then guru meditate in a bit over that. Yeah, but so much to that. The issue is, of course, that Navarro knows that people in companies cannot develop software. I work for one and beat the developers every day for it. So are you a developer? Are you not a developer? The question is, are you one of those people who can develop or cannot develop? Yeah, for me, this is also really like, why can there be always, it's not like one time, it's like each time you update something major, it doesn't build quite flawlessly. So if you wonder, did we update binutils already? Maybe binutils. Probably too little TL, too late. Yeah, I mean, binutils probably should be relatively safe, I guess. I mean, the other question is, well, glibc also works sort of. Also not this, but this. And why is there not glibc? What? Not update that? Probably not. Slightly, whatever. So most stuff builds, but the issue is we desperately really need glib though. So the good thing is, means the most of the rest of the build goes probably a little bit quicker, but you see even on this massive beast of a Threadripper, again, recurring theme, the serial configure time is really killing it. Means the rest is also many small packages. The big packages are glibc on this epic monster of a Threadripping Ryzen, or Ryzen Threadripper, although it's not a Threadripper. Anyway, just making a little fun of AMD naming. Kernel 6 minutes, GCC 8 minutes, glibc 5 minutes or something of that sort. But otherwise, we have already built over 20-something% of this sort, which, by the way, we can probably also update commits this build package in terms of include stage number in verbose. Package, what do you call that, header, package, verbose in, whatever, condition we're in, verbose, look, whatever, well, we are lucky that at least so much build, of course, I've hidden S-trace as per usual for forgetting the build time. However, we will see this because this was the S-trace in the cross build. We will in the final result, because due to the way T2 is configured as stopping at vital as in bootstrapping stuff, later in the default configuration, it will just continue from now on T2 in stage, okay, we are in stage 3, but after, from stage 5, T2 will continue even on build errors because the basic vital stuff is there. You can change this, but that's the default. So we will correctly record that here for S-trace and GCC. I temporarily work around it with disabling sanitizers. But the issue is glib we vitally need for package config, in my opinion, really stupid dependency, but that's what it is in, since many years, since a decade. Let's see, what are your attempts? We checked this already the other day for you, and I loaded mod IT89 for you earlier. So not that high, you see, and this is again the same Noctua previous video, Noctua NH15 something, and running with only one fan. This the second fan of the package is there in stock because noise level, and then only with one fan and low noise adapter, and yeah, 68 in my opinion it is okay for a pretty silent machine, and 68 it's a die, and 50 something at the core complexes here, at least according to this printout, and yeah. What init system and service manager are you running? Well, T2 has packaged many except systemd, although maybe do we have a system, not really sure, but I'm personally just running the good old-fashioned this 5 init stuff because, yeah, we also have run it and mean it and whatever. I personally, well, I sometimes have tested the others just a little bit, but mostly I just run the good old-fashioned this 5 init because why not? Navarro says he's not a developer, mainly planning and telling people to fix stuff, but think quite good at writing software, but really actually I'm theoretically physicist. That is amazing. So yeah. But then of course with higher load you see serial configure stuff running. So with higher load, maybe theoretically I should check. Actually, now that I mod props this, I slightly wonder if My own thing would come up with temperatures. Now that we mod probe that does this, then we would have the temperatures. No, it does not. That is a pity. Probably another tomorrow or somewhere. I need to. Or don't know. So yeah, this is another day I need to fix this. So this is an issue of some drivers enumerating some a little bit differently there. So as far as, well, so far so good. We are lucky that not so much stuff needs package config, but as soon as we hit something with package config, massive build errors will occur, unfortunately. But let's grab the tea. This K10 driver is patched, right? We've done this in the previous video. This is why probably everyone should share, like, and subscribe for the most in-depth upcoming YouTube channel here. That is on T2. Well, it's upstream. We made the video. This is one of the few patches. We try to keep patches out of here, but okay, fine. The search takes longer than just typing Linux. Oh, it's not IP30s there. So this is K10. So this is import from the upstream. So this should be in the next kernel, but for now you can grab it here if you want. There is a slightly newer version. I've not yet bothered to import that, but if you want this right now, then you can. What is this? Oh, this was this nonsense. So yeah, but it's coming to 5.5 or something most likely. And this is really exceptionally. Usually I really try to keep stuff plain vanilla, raw like sushi and stuff, but just some really nice to have, and yeah, like set standard compression. For example, one of the few distributions using set standard compression, like maybe nearly the only one, I guess probably maybe for the kernel initrd stuff, a patch from Facebook people that I voted already multiple times. If you Google this, I already like 5 times like voted on the Linux kernel. It's like, yes, please, it's amazing. Yeah, because just like sets down the compression so much better than all the other stuff also. So yeah, let's make some tea because tea, and also how many build errors do we have? Okay, only one, but this will soon change. And we are still building GDB 165. Yeah, also this build, on the other live stream, we built the minimal. In the meantime, I switched because we published the minimal ISO. In the meantime, yep, no worries. Thanks for joining. Have a good rest of the day too. I wonder, so the issue really is glib. This is so annoying. I wonder, so what is version number now? The question is, how far do we get with, well, what's this glib stuff. But yeah, on FreeBSD and stuff, stuff just builds, and on Linux, those people constantly break things. It's really, really a pity. What else was there? So there was this Python stuff. Probably we can still sometime soon tweak the Python stuff. Yeah, that is true. FreeBSD. So comments all against American rights. FreeBSD doesn't have a very good graphics acceleration from the. So yeah, they constantly sync with Linux stuff. So you basically get the same as on Linux, except there is more stuff broken because not. Not as many people test and zunk there, which is, yeah. So now we build glibc32, which we don't really need that much, but whatever. Certainly should build relatively. But this is also the disconnect of people on Phoronix like, yay, new glibc without. I mean, often it's of course not even noticeable faster. I mostly did this here now at night for, well, eventually we need to do it anyway, and then I can also live stream it and entertain you. But aside from this, it does not really give us much except new issues, barely new features, barely something faster. Yes, there are some new syscalls there and some 32-bit year 2036 mitigation and stuff, but aside from that, it's like, yeah. So yeah, not really. So maybe we are obviously nearly the first to try this, as Google doesn't even find something with Gentoo or Fedora or Debian. So as usual, as it was back in the day and is today, often our unsuccessful one-man distribution, the first to try all this fun stuff out. Maybe also sometime soon I should actually theoretically write here scripting parallel building of packages to mitigate the serial configure time, because theoretically if packages are not depending on each other, we could in parallel compile libatomic and m4 or other stuff. If we improve our dependency resolution, then we could theoretically do that and certainly much more load here our massive parallel stuff. I mean, at least you see, thankfully, not as much depends on glib. Of course, it will GNOME desktop and stuff, but this could parallel computation. This could theoretically, so if the whole build takes 3 hours and it's mostly bottlenecked with serial configure time, if we in T2 compile like whole packages in parallel, for example, S-trays and like stuff totally not depending on each other, like building, like first building compiler and stuff, but eventually if the base stuff is built and then like building M4 and set standard and like all the stuff that doesn't depend on each other in parallel would theoretically, yeah, easily maybe from 3 hours to less than 1 hour if we are lucky or something of that sort. But yeah, first we need to get through this build. I actually wanted to publish this Xorg, so minimal Xorg, that is what we have done live on the other channel also, but it's so much to hear. Let's try this and then at the end you still don't have an ISO because glib, nah, but let's see, maybe we are so lucky that it's complete enough. I wonder if how much Xorg, well, maybe Xorg and Mesa still don't depend on glib, but not really sure. I would hope it doesn't, but you never know what the people smuggle in there nowadays. Also here, theoretically, this is also not wasteful. The set standard compression stuff should be done in the background somehow. Maybe I wonder, maybe let's see if we can, is this in, let's see, create We could do like not instead of not waiting, let's like program here something. Glocus asks parallel compilation with make flex or disk CC. No, we do this already. So even theoretically, disk CC or stuff was supported in ROC Linux already 15 years ago when we all had only single CPU systems. I'm not talking single packages. I'm talking so that we are doing already here with, you see a parallel building 32 jobs. This is already using dash J whatever on all of this. I'm talking about, because it's configured now, you see right now this is serial only using one core for the most part. This is why the package compilation with this kind of stuff, where configure consumes most of the time on one core only. In T2, that the T2 build scripts like build multiple packages, like T2 knows, okay, we need to build 300 build jobs, but we can build M4, Perl, and stuff in parallel, so that building like 8 packages or 32 packages in parallel, like avoiding the whole congestion here of bottlenecking with bloody configure time. And we wanted to do this already 15 years, just that our automatic derived dependencies are not accurate enough, and it was like 15 years ago, it wasn't that vital, and then the last 10 years I've done more desktop software and other embedded software and project stuff, and just wasn't a priority. So we wanted to, I wanted to first of all build target. I was thinking like maybe have fear of a boss. Okay, maybe not. Or actually build the calling build package here, right? Okay, let's build. Sorry, maybe I should mute the microphone for that. Actually, not even that I have a cold. It's just like all the talking. So it means thankfully something builds, but yeah. S-tray certainly is also nice stuff, but S-trays I certainly like leave for Debian people to fix or something. Not like I fix everything for everyone. Fun fact, the most, I really wonder why on our company website, I checked this the other day, I think on the Exacode website, I said this already before that on our websites, a lot of people from Google and stuff access our website, like our amazing T2 catalog of building stuff, but also on our company website, the most, just the start of February, but January here in the statistics of number one host accessing our, we were overtaken by some, but the second like 1,180 hits on our company website from TX, not sure if TX102 something dot redhat.com, if TX stands for Texas, no idea, but yeah, so second most access on our company website, which doesn't even have that much Linux information from Red Hat, not making this stuff up. Let's see, create tarball, what are we building now? As you see, otherwise I would have guessed, but now here, nice, really happy with it. Here's binary package. I slightly wonder if we just like for a quick hack can run this here in the background with ampersand of grabbing this stuff, because mostly we don't really need to wait for this, right? So like why would it be package loop package? And then here for all of this, creating binary package, because this, as you see, it's again like stalling a little bit, like in at this kind of time quite a lot. Yeah, like where would the ampersand go here? All right, this is temp files, so so much to this ampersand, but CD here. It's a pity we have this temp file thing here, otherwise we could have just have an ampersand there if we wouldn't do this temp file thing. J American already writes, when will we provide an updated ISO? Well, we had one last week, right? You mean an updated one from last week, like this, depending how broken, maybe this, not maybe tonight. depending how broken it is. We could, for a test, you know, let's just like for a test, what are we building? We're building PPL. Let's for a test, like comments this out, and not sure if it goes there. Let's like cancel this and see what happens. Maybe I should have, I wonder slightly, I have it like echo something test and that. Yeah, that should work. Maybe depending on the surrounding. It's of course a quick hack, not sure what side effects it has. It's always like, yeah, let's see. How many do we have of this is probably here. Wait a second. No hub here is something. What is that even? Ah, demon mode. Oh, interesting. Fun stuff of good old fashioned times that we have here. Yeah, I mean, this can just run in the background. Maybe we should have. Oh, yes, scam. Okay, actually, maybe the whole thing should then like removing temporary tarp preset. Do we still use this scam? I think not really. Well, to. Actually, see, what do we build now? No, probably now we shouldn't disturb this shell script here, while otherwise we waste all the GCC compile time. J-American, did you try T2 already, or all the live streams just making you wondering so much? Or curious how it will be. So glib, so yeah, now 5 glib fails correctly. Why did PPL, alright, PPL we just manually canceled so much too. That x86 already unlock 5 PPL of that sort. So Jim Rickroyds didn't see the 2020 build, went straight to the stable folder. All right, so the stable, did I probably I should rename that. I sort the versioning. We did not really progress in versioning anyway. Maybe I should actually probably then rename the stable to vintage, or the whole stuff to old, maybe. Or maybe we leave it just now for now. Anyway, but you can wait for this build if you want, and because then you have the latest and greatest, so the most up-to-date Linux distribution out there like right now, because it is the fun of our fully automated, except if it fails and needs some manual intervention because there are upstream regressions. I was actually wondering while we wait here for this test, although it's a little bit stupid now that we have just this big GCC to test our backgrounded tar creation. Let's see, do we call build package for probably for all of those, I guess, and yes, command build package, and that means we could make this verbose. Do we have here a verbose variable or no? What do we have? We're still building GCC. When GCC is done, I will actually. So you built your 3950X, so like finished, or what exactly do you mean? Test when sounds the build is ready. So yeah, then congratulations to your build. How are your temperatures, by the way? How are you cooling it? And but I think you posted the picture the other day, right? So I will change here also to support -v for verbose, like on the others. Then I don't always need to switch this build to verbose. It's actually should probably be somewhat handy. Let's see, 5 GCC. I was also thinking, so of course most of the packages all, well, some packages have some percentage counter, but it would, yeah, but maybe it's a little bit overdoing adding there some pseudo somewhat guesstimated percentage counter, but just another idea. So as soon, yeah, so this is installing. Very theoretically, we could add a timer here, then you see how far, how long it is building already, like timer relative to beginning of the package there. So yeah, we don't have, let's see, we should have a tar running. Do we have some, let's see, does it work? Grep set standard of grep tar or there is this running, so we could actually check and build. So maybe this, I mean, it should certainly work. The question is only how stable and reliable. For example, it could have an issue with, this is still, so there you see, we would still have this build stalling. So there's again some efficiency gain. The only question is now what happens in case of a build error? Is this then like terminating the child jobs there as a shell, which would kill this tarring away? But yeah, this details that have to be seen as soon as we have some issue of some sort. But yeah, so this is certainly quite some win here in terms of efficiency already. And then the next thing would be skipping the entire configure phase. So Jamerican writes, completed for the most part, trying to avoid water cooling. Use Fumo, be quiet friends. The temp range is from 30 to 70. When I really push it, it goes to the 80s. That's interesting. Well, I mean, considering that I have only one fan on this, one Noctua fan, and running this, what do you mean with really pushing it? I think if I'm like really pushing for like 10 minutes of a Linux kernel build, then it's like 80s. Actually, right now we are pushing it quite a bit, as you see, although it's not even like fully, totally, perfectly, 70. Even a full Linux distribution build with all the serialized configure stuff and such is only pushing it to some degree. So 72 here, if we are talking about the same TDI temperature. Monero, okay, such stuff we don't do here. Glaucus, any idea what package might be causing such problems? M4, error, enter file and string. I have no idea. Is this your own build? Maybe it's Musl related. Sometimes, speaking about decades of experience, sometimes I had stray stuff of stuff miscompiled or like bugs in the C library of like read, write, memory map, whatever stuff could go wrong there. Not sure if the temps are reliable because of K10 temps. Yeah, that could be that this is slightly off though, indeed. But so let's see, what do we have here? I actually didn't compare it further with anything else. Yeah, 72 right now, we're pushing it a little bit. Yeah, as you see, this is certainly pushing it quite a bit. So yeah, so far only glib, which is somewhat surprising. I would have thought more stuff failed already. Probably we can't have package config, so probably we have not, we have not built something that needs package config. What was, right, glib needed meson, so we need to wait until we have meson here. 100% on all threads. It's like similar to this probably, so I mean this is probably right now with not delaying it for tarball creation and 73. I mean, I'm pretty happy really. 73 is really bonkers you've seen on this video, I'm surprised if you're new to this channel, we also built here this 3950X, which theoretically maybe another day we could show that a little bit with camera angle change to more like where it's even can be. Move this slightly maybe, but I probably would need to change it quite significantly. Maybe I move the stuff a little bit around sometimes. So why is, by the way, what is, or do we, or is this, because of this, this looks funny in the graphical. So this, on the videos, if you're new to this channel, we also built the 3950X on this other video, and I did not even change the thermal compound, right? So I had the Mini ITX build, the new Curonaut or so, a thermal grizzly Curonaut, not a paid advertisement. And can't update Chrome, yes. And I'm surprised, like nobody, I was like, okay, fine, a fine film of thermal components, but yeah, okay, let's, maybe we change it anyway, let's leave it like this for a test. And it looked quite fine, in my opinion. The less the better anyway, maybe. I'm surprised nobody commented like I'm such an idiot of not putting the new thermal compound, because it was only a week old, right? So it was 1 week previously with a stupid applicator, which I hate. It's probably the biggest garbage ever. And I'm surprised like nobody said like, yeah, you can't do this one. But anyway, you see old thermal, a thin film of old, a week old thermal compound there. And it's still amazing. Maybe it's even better with like super thin layer. And given this is old thermal compound from a year old, and one fan, also it's a huge one, whatever, 14 or whatever centimeters it was, no idea, 15, whatever. Low noise, right? Because thermal throttling, like a Mac Pro, and for that I'm certainly more than happy with this low noise build here. Previous video there on this. Let's see. Use to see a course loading, Noctur, NTH1 thermal paste, will try Curonaut thermal. Yeah, so this Curonaut, I never tried this. I'm only new, decades ago I built PCs, I'm only new to this because failing Macs. And this Curonaut, previously, like decades ago, I always had some 5 gram tube from some local electronics store, some $1, no-name garbage stuff. Also, 15 years it wasn't a thing. It's like, yeah, there's one cheap thermal compound and that's it. And like on a K6 and Pentium 120 and Athlon 600 and stuff. And now with this fancy stuff, the first time I tried this, there's some whatever 5 gram or whatever that was. I used this one tube for the Mini ITX, so the 2700, this upgrade, and some other random stuff like, yeah, thermal, the G5 upgrade, previous video, Apple G5 2.5 gigahertz upgrade, and I used it everywhere. It's still it's the first 5 gram or whatever that was too. So yeah, so 23 amps, 50, you see all the serialized configure time and installing, what is that even, BI, so this open SSL, whatever that is doing there, configuring something. Due to that, of course, we are cooling down, and this is exactly this serialized per package stuff I'm talking about. Yeah, usually I didn't cape the thermal compound, so Jamerican was also surprised. Yeah, I was, if this would not have worked, well, probably I applied a little bit too much on this initially, because I honestly really hate this applicator. Back in the day, we never had such stupid applicator thing, and in my opinion, doesn't even work too well. I would probably in the future not continue to use the stupid applicator thing. And yeah, considering it looked like a thin film, so it looked like this is a stupid applicator, most likely it was even too much. And as it was probably a little bit too much, I thought like, yeah, well, it's a thin film, so let's try it out and can't complain. Most likely, I noticed, however, I left from the smaller Mini ITX fan, I left this mounting brackets on the motherboard, and I noticed only at the end that the NH15 or something mounting brackets are larger a little bit. So of course the holes and stuff are the same, but on the rear side, on the back side of the logic board, it's like a little bit more metal, and they are black. The Mini ITX NH, whatever that was, 665, I guess, they were silver, so maybe just for the super optical fun of it, maybe eventually I will just, yeah, it's not, of course, totally not necessary, but given that it's like 90 degree mounted, maybe I switch this brackets another week or something eventually if I'm bored or something of that sort. So yeah, build is continuing. Let's see, also create error list. So far, I mean, we are super lucky that not, if more stuff, in my opinion, this glib library is also really stupid. This low-level C abstraction stuff is like, yeah, also super overcomplicated because they put everything in the kitchen sink. But somewhat lucky. Imagine if GCC and each small package would use glib for everything, then we would have already 200 build errors here. But here's still 251 to go. We had some big ones. So we have glibc, gcc, okay, core utils is medium large. Eventually, yeah, ironically, I say we should make more progress with small packages like all the small drivers, but relative, of course, we could make fast progress with build errors and all the glib based stuff hits soon and we don't find a solution for this stupid symbol issue there. So yeah, so far so good. So far we had, again, for those who tuned in new, we had S-trace not solved, so S-trace whatever. GCC sanitizers of like, yeah, not really using it mostly anyway. The biggest issue, glib of some private symbol name clashing whatever stuff. And yeah, theoretically, so find utils, I wanted to tweak this target a little bit just for the fun of it, meaning having here like verbose equals probably nothing, and then like dash v verbose equals one, and then package build package of here command build package of theoretically we could actually put here like verbose like this if we just let's see command prefix like something of that sort. This, the only drawback of this is it will leave a space if if not set, but this is only relatively minor. It's like, yeah, whatever. Then we could make this here verbose equals we, that would probably be what are we, so we're compiling grep, which, okay, grep is, it's configure and small, let's save that. So then we can try our new feature of supporting dash v everywhere. 64 config, let's disable that for, oh, wait a second, are we compiling without tempfs? Are you freaking kidding me? Was this the right? Apparently we were building without tempfs, what a fail. Wasting a little bit of 86-64. Because we are running from the USB 3 connected Samsung SSD stuff, because portable development stuff. Because this I can plug out and continue at home and stuff. And yeah, I could log in remote, but it's anyway, all right, we now need to rm, here's a log file of, because we control C that, we need to wipe that. So as you see, so we disabled verbose. Of course, this is now not verbose, and let's cancel it and test this verbose instantly. Let's see if that switches to verbose. So yeah, that works, fun stuff. Then probably, we, okay, the only thing is maybe I commit this tomorrow, because right now I have two changes in there. I for sure will not commit this experimental change of backgrounded compression stuff there that is probably too fragile and error prone to maybe cause some side effects. Yeah, but you see also grep, this is my recurring shout out, this configure checking so much unnecessary garbage, nonsense, random noise and whatever, that the build of grep was faster than the stupid long configure time. That's probably SED also, like configure forever, my recurring theme of, yeah, not amazing. And then, yeah, I mean, it's configure checking so much garbage, it compiles faster with 32 threads anyway, it's hilarious. Design fail anyway. Anyway, you see now the small packages, now this counter will go up rather quickly here of this. Yeah, so half done, then probably somewhat more than half done, because GCC, glibc were huge. Now we have tar. Nah. So here, also maybe theoretically we, you know what, let's clean this up in parallel because, you know, I can even make a copy. Let's maybe copy this to T and it's because why not fix this here in parallel. So that would be putting this. Anyway, yeah, let's finish it a little bit more. Then what do we even want this? We also want this at the end of a line like here. And then that was temp here and move this back like that. And save this again. So then CNDI and okay, this is a semicolon. Search for semicolon at the end of the line that we need. What is this here? Do we need this? Or this is GNU org. That is that, that is that. This is that. Okay, maybe it would have been faster to memorize the build line number. Anyway, so scripts commit. This should be just the verbose stuff of support v for verbose and scripts build target. And then of do we call this compressor or somewhere of here. So to make this here like more, I would say so building where is even creating so. Okay, the issue is a little bit the status printout. Let's see. Sort building. Sort var RDM, the rest. File. Maybe we get rid of this. I slightly wonder if can we not make this. Oh, wait a second. Oh, this is this. R. Okay, this is this. Where is this compress? Creating binary package 4. Building packages. Can we not have this in one line? Why do we need two status lines for that? Because the issue is running this in the background. Not really sure how well this. We don't really need so many status. I'm really only worried that if we run this, all of this in the background, this might actually work. Let's see if that works. Create so like what is this grep version? So file, so like after here. And then the status of building binary package. Building binary. Oh, wait a second. We don't have the file here yet. But maybe we move this just binary package. Maybe we just move this down. It doesn't need to be here yet. Like mkdz, then creating this stuff, and then the status printout here when we know the file name. The file should probably be, don't tell me you set it later. No, file is here, so yeah, that probably should probably work. Let's try that. And also, we need to run some. Oh no, we failed on glib. And so there's the glib. Or did we? Oh, I didn't. So there's the glib. This is a native build. This is now the final conclusion. Oh, Mason. Why do we not have Mason already? Oh, yes, by the way, now adjust. Yeah, so this is one line now. I think this is probably good that we only need one line for that, I would think. Maybe we built it here then in parallel. Target config x86-64 job 5 Mason, not really sure. Let's see what happens. So there we built Python, not really, but also Maze. Maybe Python needed. All right, you know what? Darn, this is a new dependency of. Darn, this is. Maybe this is why I didn't have the latest glib version, because this was building with Mason and. Or was it? Darn, all these issues always. Let's see, tonight show starting. What do you mean? You mean like another tonight show, not this tonight show? Or what do we have now? Dependency CMake, runtime dependencies. What library M found? Yes, what the heck is that even? Maybe we revert this glib anyway. Right now we have some. What do we even have here? Did we convert it already to Mason or not? Oh no, we converted it already to Mason, but anyway, let's build this again. He's saying you stream like a TV show at night. Oh, you mean staring? Oh, I should also read more closely. Yes, thank you very much. Much appreciated. This was one of the things I was actually thinking, whether you mean this tonight show or another tonight show. So what did we fail now? Runtime dependency. Okay, it probably libffi. Let's see what this does. Mostly I only manually. Why is this? Also slightly wonder if this correctly created. Okay, maybe we check this another day. With our now backgrounded compression stuff, whether that cancels, aborts the job or not. Let's see if that is doing something, because CMake found runtime dependency lib. So normally, of course, this manually messing around is not required. This is only because we failed glib cross-compiling it, and now I'm curious if native compiling changes the thing. Not sure if we have PCRE2 in there, but probably apparently not. We can already try this here in parallel of job 5 glib. And yeah, I have the feeling PCRE2 was not part of this minimal build, but so what, it's not failing found CMake package config. I tried package config and CMake, or it needs package config already. What a fail. So okay, wonderful. Do we need CMake? We could probably, okay, it's also hilarious that it's like trying CMake for checking something. Let's see, or did we? Probably I should have checked if we. That would be build x86. CMake, did we? Ah, we built this array, so now wasting some CPU cycles. Okay, so the real issue is that. Should we? The real issue is that we have the circular dependency of package config needing glib, and glib didn't build. It's probably also not a crossing. We can cross compile thing, because pretty sure the same thing would happen on a native build. Glaucus writes, these builds are what's getting. So you're watching our failing builds while your builds are failing, I guess. yeah, so glib starts. I really, so probably we really have to investigate what's up with the stupid stuff there is. Also, maybe now we don't touch it. Usually we touch this as T2 is using. Probably not here. Okay. Let's move this now. Usually I just touch this, but then we lose the log file. And if we move it, then obviously we still have it to further analyze it. What are the same files that we want to look? So this is interesting that maybe this was actually, maybe the shell was actually waiting for the background job because this was hanging a little bit, which would be the intended behavior. Let's see, do I have the commit scripts build target? Yeah, I have this with an ampersand, so all the stuff should run in the background, which would be pretty cool, which is, in my opinion, the... Actually, we could probably test this if we start a new bash and then mark sleep 10 in the background and sleep 10 in the background. And then, oh, this exits immediately. Okay, anyway, whatever. So then let's continue the build. So only... issue is I'm quite okay. We don't have package config. That will be quite a fail. We don't really need to Well, we can continue it, and half of the stuff will build or more, while we guru meditate over this symbol stuff. So let's build temporarily without tempfs to capture the build output, then build the stupid one glib, which of course will fail the build again, like that. So yeah, this is only manually fiddling around. Why does lib input? Okay, lib input probably fails also due to some glib stuff, I guess. Yeah, of course. So, I mean, we can already waste some CPU cycles for that test building. And in the meantime, guru meditate over this stupid stuff. Can't make it up. yeah, the glibc is also, so glibc is natively rebuilt. Oh, darn it. And so what was the meson? So I usually grab here the log file to rerun exactly what was our Ninja. So we're compiling this with Ninja. Actually, it could also be, we had in the previous video some build error in something earlier today on the More Life channel there. That was due to meson. So what is going on here? That is in which directory is it even, or is it running this on? GIO. No such file or directory. Sorry. GIO, where is this, or is it, ah, it's an object here, probably like that. That is how it's running this, so, is needed, one, no, undefined, start group, is any of those fancy, so I wish, or does it, hey, it has fancy navigation, since when does this work, amazing stuff. I mean, sometimes let's be honest, sometimes stuff is also amazing if it sometimes works, so sometimes it doesn't. I mean, we can try if any of this fancy linker stuff is causing any of this. Group ended before it begun. What the heck? Is needed, no undefined. Well, we can, okay, so startup group. We also that probably at once. End group. So what? It's actually the first time I see the startup group stuff. Okay, it still doesn't work. Undefined. I really wonder why this is in libRT though, which is part of glibc, which is really like really hilarious. It's not even used in glib or what? I mean, all the other, it's also really hilarious, all the other programs work, right? But just linking RT also works. It's hilarious. I really mean, all the GNU people and stuff, and then they produce this stuff that just doesn't. I mean, the most bizarre. And now we get more build errors there, by the way. For. Yeah, font config and stuff. That is really unfortunate, though. Someone has probably not googled that right. Always on the forefront of build errors. I mean, I slightly wonder if so control and alt on this shell right now behave the same. I wonder, so if the startup group is only some optimization thing, most likely we probably should Google that. But if removing all of this stuff here does fix the thing. Origin stuff, libdir stuff, origin g module, rpass link, undefined reference to g3. Or maybe this is, okay, maybe this is some fancy stuff of, like you marking them that they always need it together or some optimization stuff. What if we just as probably needed marking those to be in some whatever optimization group or whatnot? Nope, same. Seriously, this is so 2020. Not even your linker works correctly anymore. The issue is, of course, I don't even really need to publish this binary now, but even if we get it to work like most of the time, it still has here this unfortunate stuff that you can't fix at home. Makes no sense to give you something that you can't really continue building your rest of your systems in. Maybe we could just compile. Glibc, they probably should be marked private or not. If we. Or is there a chance that it's linking? Hope it's not using the. This is due to some stupidity using. Wait a second. It has here user lib. End user lib, maybe it's using the system. What is this garbage here? Maybe it is causing this due to, I mean, theoretically, you know what, we can see this with istrace e open o log and then it's using at least here that one. And we could try, I think it's of course hard to see with the programs also opening it, but one last shot here on that one, because why not. So g module origin user source user, or is it just anyway using this for runtime, this origin thing? It doesn't make a change. Okay, fine. What is in root user lib 64 libc so? Also, well, very theoretically, it could also be a bin utils regression, right? For now that I think about this, maybe we should try with reverted bin utils. To be honest, that's the issue, is not in glibc but in binutils. That was grep set time, because it tests here 225. What does it not find? It doesn't find clock set time. Well, theoretically, it is also not really with underscore, though. And not really glibc private. Does it even have private? It has some private, though. So, bug in binutils or bug in glibc? So much to having this already committed. Development binutils. That and maybe stop the build for a second, and then let's job zero binutils. Let's rebuild binutils, so that should be 233.1. Probably also end this live stream sometime soon, though, because midnight. But we will finish this result of binutils, and then what exactly do you mean with free versus non-free? Do you mean like binary only driver stuff? So what have we built here now? That yeah, 233. Let's, so this is a cross-compiling binutils, then let's see two glib, one glibc cross-compiling this with the latest binutils here. Binary only. But what exactly do you mean with open source packages like distributed binary only at Red Hat or binary only like games or Intel compiler or I need here more constant T supply though. So what will we getting? I mean glibc should be enough, so then this glibc, this cross-compile glibc should be being assembled by our freshly bootstrapped cross kind of binutils assemble linker thing. And then, so that probably should be over in just a second or so. Mostly driver based, like Vulkan. Yeah, okay, so driver based, I much prefer open source drivers. So I never like really touch this AMD binary only stuff because I don't like messing with black boxes that may work or may not work and then limit me like with this binary only. Like here, of course, this is an example of the worst maintained garbage here of Epiphan fame. Previous video here. Because each time I capture, I need to boot in this old binary kernel there, Fedora core kernel something for this one. So in my opinion, mostly annoying, pain in the ass. And if yeah, driver certainly, I much prefer this stuff than open source. Also that in case I want to change something like P3, also the reason why do we not have more amazing graphic on the P3, because yeah, I can reverse engineer everything myself again. So yeah, okay, this still failed. Thank you very much. Very theoretically, we could probably work around that very little bit. Package, okay, let's one more try to get this maybe a little bit more bootstrapping, which will be a really dirty workaround now. Dirty hack revert binutils ld glob off disk. So then let's revert the glibc for a second and build the old glibc, cross compile this glib, and then continue with the new one. That will be really dirty hack, but whatever. SVN up, SVN log less. So that would be. Oh, wait a second, we have not committed this yet, right? Okay, right. Okay, let's just commit this because why not? Doesn't really change so much anyway. Commit glibc, glibc 32. And commit this also, not really, maybe not the most amazing working. And then, all right, we can revert this. I only committed this for having it version, and then we can, as we merge, reverse, revision, merge that here into there. And also, okay, SVN up. Okay, so it was a little bit mixed indeed. No, we messed it up a little bit. Darn it. Can't mix the stuff up. Shit, it's not what I wanted. Fuck, man. What have I even? So initially we merged that, which was wrong, which was even what was the 93, which was kind of the right. What the heck have I done now? Maybe also not past midnight. I mean, the good thing is that this repository was super clean, or mostly clean. It's just some merge info. Some of this doesn't look quite right. it did not work. Well, we could also update to this revision. Yeah, that worked at least. Oh, wait a second, not merged, what the heck? Okay, anyway, maybe we... Okay, anyway, so then let's rebuild binutils again, the latest version. In the meantime, clean out our merge method. How could I mess this up? I mean, most of this stuff is now... what the heck did I even mistype there? Or is it a... No idea how that happened. Revision didn't look too wrong, so strange stuff. Okay, binutils built. Then the slightly older glibc, just to have hopefully a glibc there or stupid glib links. Although this is also testing whether just the new glibc, just new binutils, builds the glibc and the previous glibc, and if this is purely a glibc issue, or mostly anyway. You wonder how that has happened. Probably everyone will tell me who's Git for that, but anyway. But yeah, as usual, leave me in the comments what you think regarding free versus non-free and binary only driver stuff and fun stuff like that. Python, I think we modified that probably. Yeah, I mean, there you see also the point of the 3950X, and without that, everything would take even longer, obviously. So glibc, let's hope that builds the latest glib, can't make this stuff up. Keep your fingers crossed. And of course, yeah, a little bit messy and tricky and trick 17 here behind the back and stuff, but really not looking more into this kind of build errors of other people. I'd rather continue our RISC-V stuff. And so, hey, that builds. So yeah, there you have it. It's not binutils, it's glibc. Live here on this channel. That also means we can now build 5 package config and continue. Hopefully, then also RM here, wipe here, RM here most of the build over errors, which probably all of them for now, which in the meantime were quite many. What do we have here? Glib 2.16, either previous installed package config could not be found. Okay, let's try. Can we cross-compile that? Probably, hopefully. Let's see. Alright, it didn't have a previous package config. Needs package config. Only live on this channel. So strace, okay, strace will fail. We know that already. So much to overwiping build error logs. So 100. So yeah, we compiled now. 300 or 500, so 3 or 5. Quite some though. So strace, actually wonder, oh wait a second, we have not, wait a second, we probably don't, we want to build glib first though, which probably, because otherwise we would know job 5 glib c to continue, otherwise the test wouldn't be fair, otherwise we would continue building now with old glibc, when in fact we want to test regressions with a new glibc, that would be beyond the point. What else I wanted actually to find? The only other real thing I wanted to fix was this Python shared file thing that didn't really even yet had a chance to look into. So many other, but well, it's more or less like it's like kind of sort of what I expected, just like not like really in glib. I expected like maybe some better FS procs or some XFS stuff, or yeah, okay, strace is usually like strace really fails often. You wonder a little bit of the code quality if that stuff is always failing, but like with each other update, but glib is really, it's like, yeah, this is hilarious. Also, I still wonder if it's like bin utils or glibc's, maybe the glib, actually maybe the glibc symbols are also incorrect. It's to be determined another day though. But you also see a testament to there's always something, it's always like this small build error, this small improvement, which thankfully we always do a couple of improvements, like for both print out here and a little bit of polishing there. So we are coming to an end already, building glibc in just a couple of, yeah, really probably timer would be cooler off. But of course, the more fancy stuff we do here, the more CPU cycles it takes. But it's already pretty cool though, my opinion anyway. So then let's target. Here, there, the problem is not, okay, we can, okay, not so far. Was just thinking of whether how to continue in parallel to not waste you some CPU cycles. So yeah, some glitchiness there. In the morning we fixed already LLVM Mesa compatibility there. And yeah, also 1,000, no, 11,000. Yeah, it's also hilarious, like in the capital of Germany here in Berlin with some 400, how much do we even have precisely? Was it 32 Mbit up? Oh. Anyway, somewhat hilarious that in this day and age you can't reliable stay with a business cable, Vodafone cable, garbage here. Also now we have some shared files of that sort, but I mean, shared files is just, now we have here some stuff, actually a couple of others are gone, we've previously had some others, but this is just from config, this is just this file, they actually probably really shouldn't necessarily be in font config though, if we edit this here and actually sbin also shouldn't really have sbin, I guess. What else was there? This only happens now mostly because see, not another. What else was it even? So fonts, oh, this 100 dpi, where is it in here? Oh, here. Probably not really that this should not be the first package built there though. Why are those failing though? Maybe I should not have deleted them though. It was just out of a reflex a little bit. Let's see what else is. Okay, we still got those. Okay, fine, whatever. Shared file is not. What is lib input having an issue now? Libudev, did we not build libudev already? Okay, maybe apparently not. Libxcb, what is that complaining about? That is Python? Ah, okay. Maybe this, I still need to change our Python package to create a symlink or something, or build all of them with Python equals something else, user bin. Then Python, yeah, you have seen this in previous video, this is really also not Python, Python and config. maybe DMX is not even really necessary. Maybe the, well, our minimal build is already so large, it doesn't really matter the small thing, but theoretically it's of course probably somewhat obsolete, outdated stuff. But here, coming at least some data points, someone needs to do this. Otherwise, if, yeah, I would probably have updated it anyway sometime soon, and then I would anyway sitting with this build errors. So yeah, I can also do even, saying 30 frames, so. Let's see, so Carlos, welcome, full Arch store with kernel, something built from zero in 1 hour. Yeah, well, but this Arch stuff, probably this Arch stuff is binary only, right? Someone needs to build this. I mean, this is what like Fedora, SUSE, Debian and so on, they do in their, down their bunker there, behind the scene. And yeah, also, this is a difference. I mean, a news benchmarking site like Phoronix could do some build and benchmark, but even if Phoronix builds glibc, they do not like build a whole system, and then they do not even realize most likely that strace breaks and glib breaks. And if we would not have this breakage and fill around with these new regressions, we would already be long done. So yeah, probably waiting for some Fedora people or someone there to fix this. Okay, most of the build errors now fixed. Most likely when we probably want to build UDEV earlier, I'm not really sure if, because lib input, I just changed lib input though to whatever, it's 127 though. What is lib input? But maybe we make this a little bit later. We can, do we need lib input? Lib input needs probably just the driver, right? Let's not change UDEV too much around. Who knows what else we break with that. Let's build this later, and that would be xorg input, and let's make this also significantly. Wonder why is this so early though. Some will have it hard to believe that it's even xorg server built so early. Somehow I doubt that, but this is a little bit, yeah, this old-fashioned technology. We really need to make this, oh, it's actually built quite early, interesting. Okay, then let's make this 170, whatever, just for the, so shared file, delete, oh, what was fdev, probably should have actually. Okay, so far so good. I mean, we work around it, this glib, we YOLO'd this glibc, not glibc, glibc related glib. Build error there with a stupid glibc private symbol garbage of whatever sort. Libfdev knows this build. So let's see. We have here, and this is only one homemade shared file stuff, and yeah, strace means this doesn't look too bad, although yeah, this build's still a little bit manually YOLO'd. Not so great to continue replicating at home, so it's always, but recurring theme, it's always like something with some Linux kernel issue or Spark PowerPC, glibc, the glibc certainly constantly causing something. I really wonder how a C library cannot be like more generally stable. This is also the thing of deprecating stuff, of removing all this Phoronix, like yay, they remove some obsolete vintage feature, but there is a downside, is like, yeah, build breakage. So yeah, probably that's really some it for today. Now it's a few later than I wanted because we streamed this build stuff for 3 hours. Thanks for watching, amazing stuff. I hope you learned something, and don't forget to share, like and subscribe. And yeah, we're building all from source. Yeah, precom. So this is pre-building the packages that you install at home that you don't need to wait to watch a day. As usual, just when you want to end the build, more people tune in somehow. So, which is of course a good thing. So well, theoretically, well, we could 147. In general, at least a little bit of T2 packaging stuff. Yeah, this is this libx vmc stuff that we just fixed. Why does this not build xvmc? No such file or what? Just fixed this morning though. At least I thought so. Don't tell me that this package needs it already there and it installs it there. Okay, so probably we need to revise this again. This is really hilarious. Maybe we revise it then once more to xorg server, sorry, xorg proto of maybe only so minus z and 1, 2, 3, so 6 to 5 and 6 to, wait a second, 7 to 6 obviously, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, can't mix this up, as this is hilarious, upstream developers, let's say, I wonder. Well, after so many years, people should really know better, in my opinion, that we still have this stuff is somewhat, also Moses failed again. All right, wait a second, why, but why? 1, 2, 3. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, wait a second, I deleted one too many. This probably should work. And here also, what was it, this one? So then let's try with just that and see if that is enough to build this. I mean, it's a little bit hilarious. It's like, yeah, why are there such upstream issues? I have no idea. Xorg proto for that build. Then let's start that again. And oh, why does no more glue? Oh, this glue needs to be later. Mazer desk. So XEV, amazing stuff. Okay, glue still. So yeah, this is all the small X11 packages that built in a fraction of a second here. American using Void Linux and had to do the same, just got a patch from Rani CPU temps. And package builds have to modify to compile using more than one core. What the heck? Seriously? That's hilarious. NT2 is generic and automatic and tested for decades because dual core PowerPC, Spark and stuff. Oh, wait a second, this is also wrong. So, 117 to go. I mean, you see all the small packages are pretty fast, except if we hit new build errors. Maybe we just continue another 5 minutes. Although my wife will be a little bit upset now in the meantime, but you've got to do what you've got to do. But yeah, only live on this channel, making T2, continuing to making T2 the greatest vanilla raw like sushi sauce distribution out there. And FreeGLUT failed because, why did FreeGLUT fail now? But we just moved them around earlier, so maybe, what does it want? OpenGL missing. Why did we not build Mesa yet? But maybe they are all not correctly behind. But I also commented earlier already that it is hilarious that we have all these packages, 118, yeah, this is certainly later, All these packages for just the Mesa demos for GLX GS and GLX info. I think by the way, Netkit RSX is already broken for a longer time since the last glibc update or something of that sort. I don't really bother to, probably something of that sort. We have Libre SSL in T2, but we're not using it yet as default. It's still, well, we have both packages and yeah, whatever, not super highest priority to me. Probably the OpenSSL people got their stuff better updated and security reviewed together anyway, so not the super very highest priority for me, to be honest. But yeah, you can choose it theoretically. Maybe we, not really, by the way, do we can check on live on this channel, glibc of, okay, fine, whatever, the two packages that was LibreSSL. If we have the latest version, 3.02, oh, actually we have cool stuff. I think I once tried to make it the default, but some packages broke due to some API, changes, and then it wasn't the highest priority. Then it was like, yeah, whatever works for me. But this, of course, you can use T2 to build your own stuff. And I would not recommend normal people to switch it out in the build. But theoretically, if you wanted to mess around, so you could even do that. Others, by the way, Linux, maybe we control C Linux. So here, now the build is so long stalled, could also just... Okay, there's an error. Just to save you 6 minutes because I want to go home. more interested in the rest of the stuff. Linux kernel certainly doesn't change the most, so 96 to go. We have more stuff indeed really built by now. What was that? Markup safe, what's that thing? We need this for Mesa, I think. Processing dependencies. This is just shared. Oh, yes, by the way, this is a shared file thing that, oh, wait a second, this is in the wrong. Maybe this is why this is erroring out. This is not correctly using lib64. that we probably should patch sooner than later. Also pth, I mean, why is this not in there? This looks like it should match, or why would this not match? Pth or ecpt. Anyway, okay, this is getting a little bit late now. To this another day. So we are compiling Mesa, yay! What we just fixed this morning on this other More Life channel, if you're interested in even more random live stuff. And we finished Mesa in just a couple of minutes. I wonder how many years of this it takes for AMD to sponsor us with some thread repo APIC. If you have good contacts or are at AMD, let us know. What do you mean with what is important in life with T2, in fixing and implementing, in commercial, in business, in life. Or in, I don't know what. So what else do we have here? Markup safe. So Mako, this is just probably my local to do here. Do we have even local to do? Probably I should have an open to-do list again. Yeah, certainly just the background tarball compression stuff should already quite improve the build times here a little bit. What was that? Again, the recurring theme of that this is RSJump or XOC driver. That is not good. XOC server, I mean, Netler. Why is Netler is in the build though? Okay, then delay RM xorg server, xorg server, and because I'm pretty sure I added Netlr earlier to the build already. Comments in the audience don't know how things is its job local. What? Maybe because I spent the entire day on the PC in the bedroom. T2 and your business. Well, theoretically, business stuff would be more important, but I would also. The issue is macOS has too many peak bugs. I certainly don't want to use Windows. So I'm now after macOS need to urgently get like 100% back to Linux because they have peak bugs. Certainly not buying a new Mac anymore. And it's also mostly for like revitalizing T2. Now with the means of YouTube, although right now I only earn not making this stuff up, I can actually theoretically really disclose that here again, because why not? Really only earning 3 error, YouTube is not receiving what? 6 embed going out though. Not making this up. I wish I would make more than $3 a day. Is it even bucks? $3 a day. But analytics, where is even revenue here? Yeah, 64. It's somewhat depressive what you make on YouTube. And long term would of course be certainly we need to soon produce more polished pre-produced videos again. But you need to start somewhere. If it would not be for in general future mission here, then I would probably not do it here right now. Then I would right now exact scan improvements or stuff like that. But also, yeah, you need to have some vision and yeah, some bigger goals. This is also, however, you see, I do this 20 years and I'm really getting, if I'm sometimes a little bit negative of like, how can this stuff be still broken and new regressions, it's also because after 20 years it's like, why is software still so, yeah, it's hilarious. And this is why also not only did I had some private fun here with this FPGA stuff, which of course now I have cables lying because I moved it around a couple of times, so FPGA fun for some personal education and stuff, and also see what we can do in business. But soon I really need to do microkernel, because the future is on the IT news stuff. We, in my opinion, we can't continue running software like most people run software on trial and error and testing, trialing stuff until something sticks and works a little bit. And for our own security and stuff, we need our own more secure than monolithic one address space micro kernel. So I'm really soon continuing microkernel stuff. So that wanted to check Netlr, did this build. So Netlr, but as usual, if you have any comment and stuff, leave it in the comments below. Change build priority before xorg server. Again, soon eventually this should be more dynamically sorted, because static priority stuff that doesn't really cut it much. Intel would actually build if we change root build xorg etc. I checked just earlier this, we probably need to somehow oh wow, that is a donation there, thanks for that super chat, highly appreciated. Xorg, what was it that we wanted? Mako, I committed. All right, I wanted to RM the net. One more. This and NV, whatever. SCS also. Yes, also. Yes, thanks for the super chat. It's really highly appreciated. It's also like, I mean, certainly I maintained this for 20 years, of course, with over 100 people, certainly over the last decades from Rock Linux, maybe even 200 people in all of Rock Linux in this decade. But I honestly, of course, I'm totally biased with doing this for 20 years. But I would not want to throw away this, so it's not like no way I would migrate to Gentoo or Arch or something. And even when we certainly, for the last decades, we've done virtualization, embedded security stuff and such, and even sometimes with T2, not always, but I would not just like use something else after maintaining, keeping this up to date. And I think this, you could argue like Python is more modern of Gentoo stuff, but I honestly think this is really nice of, as an administrator, this shell stuff is what you work with the whole day and you can easily read and work with this package description, and the stuff is not nearly unpatched like generic stuff and just like configured in some reasonable way that the stuff is supposed to be configured. So while I'm biased, I still think this is a pretty clean setup and like it's totally transparent. Also, I criticize Gentoo with the SGI patches of having this strangely packed in a tarball, which in my opinion, which I still stick to my opinion of, this is not a way to distribute software, like packing tarballs unversioned somewhere. And from this point of view, I much prefer this kind of very cleanly sorted setup of package description, and in theory can be used to compile on other systems too, so maybe we should also do this sometimes more. But again, highly appreciated. That is of course a pretty major contribution, and happy to hear that you appreciate it. I did the last 20 years sit here just in the office or in at home, which actually honestly I'm certainly like doing this for the $3 a day of YouTube AdSense. Although if it eventually becomes more, that would be nice. But certainly for my life, it would be more convenient and more comfortable to sit on the couch at home with my wife, with a small laptop on my lap and fiddling with this build while watching a movie or whatever. So certainly doing this here live on YouTube is a much more additional effort than enjoying life in a living room. But nonetheless, I hope you learn something and inspire people to do more quality software and stuff like that. And sandboxing feature to not by default. Actually, we certainly could integrate this stuff, but this would be additional stuff of configuration. So like, because you would build it like vanilla upstream configured, but you could, this is of course also theoretically the point of this target, that you, if you use this for a product, say an even Android phone or security appliance, that you could in your target modify in a generic way packages of other Saronic technology or configuration that you see fit and should. We have, there are companies, I mean many I don't even know, but I heard like even at some parcel companies they might use stuff based on T2, and I know from mailings on the mailing list that some hotel IPTV provider somewhere in Europe is using T2 for hotel specialized hotel setup boxes of digital hotel IPTV stuff and stuff like that. And I once supported, except security, where sometimes I probably should not even say where some stuff was used. But another thing I heard, I think maybe partially on the mailing list, I think some environmental controls in some buildings were like, you could say, Internet of Things stuff, like even a decade ago before Internet of Things stuff was a thing. So it's not like T2 is not used anywhere. We also have other people on the mailing list or channel, except even additionally, people on Puppy Linux used it as a base, sometimes building some Puppy Linux packages, like some size optimized and reduced. The Puppy Linux, often a little bit creative, mixing Debian and T2 binaries or Slackware binaries, SAC fit a little bit, throwing everything together and seeing what sticks. Hey, NetPBM might be a new regression, NetPBM, because I think this built previously, so maybe this is some new glibc. JBig something off here. So this is how most likely a genuine glibc regression looks like, because I'm like 100% sure that built previously in the morning. So undefined reference to power finite something, wherever that is coming from, in case you were wondering. Undefined reference, we had this log, log on power log 10 finite. So yeah, first time in my life I see such a build error, but you know, whatever. Most likely from the new glibc, because they are regressions. That's what people in big companies like, and probably depends their business on. And yeah, 21 actually, so we are nearly done the last 21. We can probably wait shortly and then we call it a night. But yeah, to answer this question, by default T2 is just like Linux, how the Linux packages are set up. But on top of this, you could innovate whatever you want. But yeah, maybe actually Dtart asked, maybe we soon should also take a look at CubeOS, how you pronounce it. What do we have now? That was scrolling so fast, IPRoute2. So actually IPRoute2 also fails sometimes, unfortunately. And this is a little bit, because this line were empty, this is now leaving this, because we print this and then carriage return and rely on the package log stuff to override it. So this is the only drawback, very seldomly seen here, for example, only TC. So very minor drawback in my opinion, that sometimes you have this stray package prefix there of this new verbose here of package stage stuff OpenSSH. So yeah, not too many regressions. I mean, one extremely annoying glib, as you've seen, that is like, that you somehow need to work around. This is of course not a long-term solution. How I YOLO'd that together there, just a little bit trick 17 there through the backend stuff. But yeah, I mean, not too many except NetPBM and S-trace, but yeah, glibc certainly, yeah, that needs to be fixed ASAP. So I need to look out for probably, yeah, honestly, I can't do this so much work here open source each and every day. So most likely as the next days I will do other stuff anyway, and also FPGA goodness. And because we just have working, fully working text, and where is even my Firefox, is there fully working, as I said already, graphic mode one bit or other if we implement more, but certainly most of all. So FPGA, some fun firmware stuff, RISC-V, because that is certainly pretty much more fun and also contributing not only maybe better education of FPGA logic goodness, but also producing something productive and not hunting others people regression, because breaking stuff every year, that is glibc's topic there for a decade or so. So this might be the nearly last package, or 9 to go. Yeah, again, closing in here, probably does it make sense? I'm not sure, do we have a glibc, I wonder. Maybe I try to install this, and if this installs, maybe I publish it tomorrow or so without too much further testing, and then updates. Actually, maybe, yeah, but again, even after this, I just now noticed the Python 3 installs into lib, not lib64. Also the shared files, so very theoretically. But yeah, that is my life. Each year, like, we can finally publish some ISOs, and then yeah, like this regression, that regression here a little bit, there a little bit, and that takes an hour, and that takes another hour, and that one night later, a weekend later, and yeah, just always a little bit much to do. Grub 2, now we're building Grub 2. It's probably, I think, the last time this worked natively. Yeah, so this only somehow, but it could be probably an old autoconf, because we are patching Grub 2 for, among other things, Apple EFI magic stuff. So that's why we need to auto regen that. And yeah, so over 3 hours, 3:30, which is of course crazy long. But that is so probably, although we spent quite a lot of time hunting regressions and quite some time making some small changes. By the way, I hope the audio was okay. I didn't, not that so 3.5 hours I was stuttering audio. of Pulse Audio fame. So, probably we should be much below 3 hour build time on the 1350X after we optimized this archiving package tables in parallel, already optimizing this a little bit away. So the next thing, the next really major thing would be fully parallel scheduling of the packages to totally mask the serialized configure times. But with that, it's really that for actually Mesa. That's it for today in the Mesa demo file. The Mesa demo is still failing. I just fixed it in the morning. This is just some build order of glue. Okay, fine. Let's fix this one more thing. Did I not really sure? Did I commit the other things of glue? Wait a second. We also first need Mesa of Mesa and then this priority for. Wait a second, glue, which order? This is certainly super way behind, so let's try something of that sort and RM. What this was Mesa. Demos. Yeah, also probably the last round of build errors will be fixed. Welcome old school, by the way. The next round of build errors will be fixed when I emerge more of this stuff on other systems that need updating, like the SG Octane P3, Sony VAIO P and stuff. And then when I emerge, well, the bulk of the build errors fixed now, but then if I emerge on my local user machines, most likely those, then the next regressions like build order stuff. But again, I have this stupid. You also should not forget this, of course, this is totally low tech, this linear scheduling priority thing. But we have done this 15, 18 years ago in 2003 or something in Rock Linux 2. And at that time, I probably had 600 megahertz or no, 2.5 pseudo gigahertz, so 1.9 gigahertz Athlon XP something. And my non-x86 machines, like the Spark was a 360 megahertz Ultra 5, still my fastest Spark, ironically. MIPS SG Octane, which back in that day I did not even have the Octane. And a PowerPC probably, I didn't even have, so probably a 800 megahertz G3 iBook or stuff. And the build took already long enough, and it was not like, yeah, we could like compute this from the dependencies, but there were too many false positives, and nowadays, of course, I still sometimes build on an Octane, but now we can of course spend more CPU cycles on like dynamically scheduling this and fixing the further improving the build time. What are we building there? Curl. Okay, fine stuff. Create early, so Mesa demo still. Did I not? What is now with the? Did we not build glue or what? What is with glue? Don't tell me we don't have glue in the config x86 packages. No, we don't. Target generic package selection, was it 40 GL? So, Mesa demos, one more. Sys files, and the build is mostly done, except this few build errors. Probably test install it tomorrow with this glib. Of course, again, a little bit YOLO fixer of, NetPBM, don't really, actually, you know what, honestly, don't really need NetPBM in this. Where is it even why do we even have it in there? I mean, probably this was like standard, but also, honestly, do we really need libungif? Maybe we shouldn't have this. I mean, JPEG, PNG, TIFF, it's probably enough for a minimal desktop. So yeah, that's it. 3 hours, 33 minutes with all the fixing in between. Welcome to Tuxutku. We are mostly through, however, you can still rewind the whole stream, and as soon as it is processed at YouTube, watch it in the archive. Thanks for watching. We managed quite a lot. Only due to all this testing. Someone, not me, I'm I have too much else to do and spend too much time on this already. I will not fix this glib. I wait for someone else to fix it. If you find a patch for this latest glibc glib issue there of private symbols or whatever, maybe you want to Google this, let me know. What stream is choppy with Raven Point? Not too many drop frames, so anyway. Thanks for watching, and see you next time. Hope my wife is not too angry right now. Yeah, hope to see you soon for all the next videos and live streams to come.